homes and some collapsed structures. Alabama has been hit with storms and heavy rain since Wednesday, and the Weather Service issued flash flood warnings around the region on Friday. Emergency declarations were also issued in Mississippi and Tennessee, the two states hardest hit by severe weather on Wednesday. The storm system on Wednesday triggered more than 20 tornadoes in Arkansas, Illinois, Indiana, Mississippi, Tennessee, and Michigan. Six storm-related fatalities were reported in Tennessee, and an 18-year-old woman was killed in Arkansas when a tree crashed into her house. This has been FPP Radio News, online at fppradio.com.
The FBI has successfully executed a raid on the Visa Corporation, exposing what could be the largest credit card scam in U.S. history. According to authorities, the Visa Syndicate for years fooled millions of Americans by issuing convincing-looking credit cards carefully designed to dupe consumers into spending far more money than they had. Investigators believe the fraudulent corporation also lured victims in with enticing rewards programs and free gifts, thereby trapping them in a spiral of debt they could never hope to repay. According to the results of a groundbreaking new study, 96% of humans would rather be a singing, dancing, animatronic bear. The study finds that a great majority of people on the planet would prefer to trade in their regular lives for one in which they sat on a plastic log, strummed a banjo, and sang songs on a stage with all their goofy bear friends. Respondents also stated that not being a sentient human being with feelings of doubt, sadness, and pain contributed to the decision.
This is the Onion News Network.
It's Free Talk Live, and it's the live Saturday edition of the program, the final live Saturday edition of this year. If I am correct about that, I think
you are correct about that.
It'll be the first at this time next year. You can join us here on the radio waves. You can bring up absolutely anything that you want. And we are live, by the way, throughout the holidays. So every single day, we're here 7 to 10 at night Eastern Time. Feel free to interact with the program. I'm Ian.
And I'm Darryl.
And we're going to start with a disturbing story that shouldn't surprise people who have been paying attention to sort of the tech world and how the government has reacted, specifically in the realm of encryption. Encryption, for those who are, you know, not really with it in the technical field, is a way to protect data that might be, let's say, mission critical for your business, like KFC. Might want to put the Colonel Sanders secret recipe in an encrypted file.
Yes, KFC, formerly Kentucky Fried Chicken, now just the letters KFC.
So they want to protect the original Colonel Sanders recipe.
The original 13 herbs and spices recipe.
Whatever those are. Or, you know, the Coca-Cola recipe or whatever. Whatever it is you want to protect from other people, you put it into encryption. And it is, you know, pretty hard to crack that stuff. Now, some encryption is better than others, and we don't need to get into the details on that. But the government is upset about this whole encryption thing. And the story coming from TheHill.com, where Congress must enact a law that would require companies to decrypt data upon government request, according to Senate Intelligence Committee Chairman Richard Burr. He said Thursday in a Wall Street Journal op-ed, quote, "Criminals in the U.S. have been using this technology for years to cover their tracks."
Yeah, criminals have also been using dollar bills and cars.
And that's true. Well, they have regulations on cars, Darryl. I mean, and dollar bills. Well, what can you do about that?
Criminals can still buy cars. They can still get dollar bills.
That's true. Burr said the time has come for Congress and technology companies to discuss how encryption, encoding messages to protect their content, is enabling murderers, pedophiles, drug dealers, and increasingly, terrorists. So you see, Apple and Google, you who are two of a myriad of companies that are implementing encryption at some level on their hardware and their software, like phones now apparently do ship with the ability to encrypt the entire phone. I don't know if that's enabled by default or not, but that is something that, as I understand it, is built in now to the operating systems of both the Apple devices and the Android devices.
How dare you try to keep your customers' data secure?
Yeah, well, that's what they're basically saying. They want to have a backdoor. They want to have a way for basically the security to mean nothing, because, you know, the reason why security is valuable is because people outside, even the creators of the security, can't crack it. they don't just put a back door in because then it wouldn't be secure at all.
Right.
And so
you can trust us to have the key, though, Ian.
No. No.
You're only giving one key, and it's to the government, and you can trust us.
Yeah, you trust the government, don't you, folks? The toll-free number here is 855-450-FREE. If you think that encryption should basically be easily cracked.
I trust the government to attempt violating my rights every chance it gets.
Yeah, that's absolutely true. The recent terrorist attacks in Paris and San Bernardino have reignited the debate over encryption. Lawmakers and investigators have said they believe the people behind those incidents likely used encrypted platforms to help hide their plans. Well, that's false. We found out that the Paris attacks, they were using open communications.
Right. No, they didn't say they were. They say we believe they were.
Right. Which is not true.
It's not true that they were, but they believe it.
Yeah, I see.
They probably also believe that, you know, this stimulus plan of injecting trillions of dollars into the economy will somehow solve the problem when all it does is create more problems that need more solutions. And what do you know? The government's right there to fix all the problems it started.
So technology has always been a double-edged sword, if you will. I mean, the internet, people for years have complained that the internet is a place where people can go to the dark side, you know, that there's all this bad pornography and, you know, bomb-making details, you know, all kinds of things that can be used for doing naughty things or dangerous or bad things. And on the other hand, the internet has been an amazing method of transferring information. Of selling things, of commerce, and being able to enrich our lives. So for, you know, all the risks associated with the internet, the positives, I think, far outweigh them.
Yes.
And I think most people can acknowledge that. So for years, people have been claiming the internet is a way for folks to distribute bad information and naughty pictures or whatever. But so what? That's what comes with freedom of speech. That's what comes with the ability to encrypt your files in this case, is that some people might use those technologies for devious purposes or deviant purposes. And that's just something that you kind of have to accept in order to have the freedom to have your own security for whatever you think is important. Maybe it's your Bitcoin wallet or, again, your business secrets or something like that.
We need to stop this Gutenberg and his printing press because it can allow people to distribute false information widely.
I bet you that was said back in the day.
It probably was.
Yeah. I mean, and all these new medias that have come out. I mean, remember VHS tapes were dangerous because they were going to kill the film industry.
Oh, right. Because people will just record whatever they want off of TV. And then
cassette tapes
were going to kill radio and all this other stuff.
I mean, people that are producing pornography or illegal pornography, for instance, are using the same technology that the government uses to produce its propaganda films. So, you know, should all cameras also be banned, you know, while we're at it here? I mean, because you're basically banning encryption. If you take what this guy says, and you do what he's wanting the companies to do, which would be, well, he wants the government to pass a law forcing the companies to break their own encryption. Then, you know, that essentially is going to put people in jeopardy and essentially destroys the idea of encryption from the get-go. Like, there's no point in having something encrypted if the government can just send a letter to Apple and have them unencrypt everything that you've created.
Right, and what part of, and what's the name of this guy? Senator
Burr.
So, Senator Burr, if you're listening, what part of the right of the people to be secure in their persons, houses, papers, and effects against unreasonable searches and seizures shall not be violated?
Well, that's the loophole word, unreasonable, right? All they have to do is say it's reasonable, and then it's constitutional.
Well,
so it's reasonable when we want to search your house.
You need a warrant to do a search.
Mm-hmm.
Although I guess based on some information that I was reading yesterday, the probable cause has been so construed that as long as they think they might find something that shows that you are somehow maybe connected to something illegal, it's okay.
Well,
which means that probable cause now is a guess of we're maybe 50% sure we might find something.
Well, we know that the government goons have raided people's homes on anonymous tips. I don't know if you were around for the Barry Cooper cop buster days, back when Barry Cooper, the former narcotics cop from Texas.
I've seen some of his videos.
Yeah, he made a cop buster video where he sent an anonymous tip into the police and had set up a house with cameras, and Christmas trees were growing under hydroponic grow lights. They raided that house, and they caught the police raiding that house on video. I mean, they busted them big time, which is ultimately why the cops came after Barry's kids and kidnapped them. Down the line, because he set them up and they fell for it.
Right.
So it wasn't hard at all to get them to raid someone's house just based on basically an anonymous letter that was sent to the police. And they do this kind of stuff all the time. So, of course, the government can just simply argue that, well, you know, yeah, there's the Constitution, but we've been violating it in this way for years, so now we're just asking to violate it in this other way.
Actually, I don't think they would say we've been violating
it. No, they wouldn't admit that, but
they would come up with all of these loopholes and weird mental gymnastic weasel words to explain in their view how they're not violating any of it, but they need to violate it a little bit more.
Well, any amount of violating your privacy is acceptable to stop terrorists and child pornographers and drug dealers, right, Darryl?
No.
Well, so you're supporting terrorism, child pornography, and drug dealing then?
No.
You're either with us or you're against us.
Am I being detained?
855 450 free. That's our toll-free number here tonight. If you want to join us, maybe you agree with Chairman of the Senate Intelligence Committee, Richard Burr, who says the government needs to be able to go to Apple and Google and whatever other encryption technology companies and just get them to unencrypt things at their request, basically. The toll-free number, 855-450-3733. I mean, terrorism. You don't support terrorism, do you? It's Free Talk Live. You can share your thoughts with us. Also, Skype in at lrn.fm.
FHA loans still work when others might not. This is Charlie Sundstrom with your Van Dyke Mortgage Minute. Here are a few of the beneficial features to an FHA loan. First, low down payments. As little as 3.5% down will work in most instances, and 5% covers most others. Higher loan amounts. In some areas, FHA maximums can exceed conventional loan limits. Lower total cash to close. Sellers can help pay closing costs, and borrowers can receive gift money toward their down payments. The FHA program continues to evolve and is a good option if your needs and situation preclude you from qualifying for a conventional loan. At Van Dyke Mortgage, we work hard to be your trusted mortgage advisor and can help analyze your personal situation and give you advice that matters. For your mortgage pre-approval and refi needs, start by visiting vandykemortgage.com.
Corporate NMLS 3035. Van Dyke Mortgage is an equal housing lender. Charlie Sundstrom, NMLS 134251.
What would your life be like if you woke up each morning with new vitality, feeling better than you have in years, and you noticed a difference in your sleeping patterns, blood sugar levels, and had a sense of well-being overall? There's something that is changing thousands of people's lives, and you could be one of them. It's called Heart and Body Extract. Sharon Harris, co-creator of Heart and Body Extract, talks about the positive effects of Heart and Body Extract.
What happens with the formula Heart and Body Extract is it's giving the body the necessary vitamins, minerals, amino acids, enzymes, and phytonutrients so the body will heal itself. And yes, the body does have the ability to balance blood pressure, balance cholesterol, clean and unclog the arteries. It can also work on balancing the circulation for diabetics. So the body is an amazing thing. It simply needs some help so it has the tools to heal itself.
Heart and Body Extract gets results. To order your 2-month supply, call now, toll free at 866-295-5305. Order online at hbextract.com.
Hi, I'm Derek J. I don't want a politician to represent me. To me, government is the idea that one group of people can coerce everyone to comply with an edict or face increasing punishments up to and including death. Despite perhaps the most noble of intentions, the best government services are a far cry from what could be provided for by voluntary interactions. Besides, the people who call themselves the government wage wars and put peaceful people in jail for crimes involving no victims. If Starbucks used some of its money to drop bombs, I wouldn't shop there. So why would I support the American Empire? The Empire does not require my consent.
Derek J's Victimless Crime Spree. Watch it for free and order the Director's Cut DVD at victimlesscrimespree.com. That's victimlesscrimespree.com. You can listen to Free Talk Live on the radio, podcast, satellite, webcam, and our live streams. But did you know you can listen to Free Talk Live from any phone, anywhere? Add this number to your phone, 213-493-0308. It's a long-distance call, so make sure you're familiar with your phone's calling plan. The listen lines are airing the latest episode of Free Talk Live 24 hours a day, including our live shows. Call 213-493-0308. That's 213-493-0308.
Silver and gold, silver and gold, how do you measure its worth? Just by the pleasure it gives here on earth.
Roberts and Roberts Brokerage hopes you have a happy holiday season and a prosperous 2016. We're available 24/7 at rrbi.co or call 800-874-9760.
Help get LRN.FM into more ears. Visit promote.lrn.fm for a free bumper sticker, flyers, banners, graphics, and more. Promote.lrn.fm.
It's Free Talk Live. Join us here. The toll-free number is 855-450-FREE, 855-450-3733. Privacy. Do you really need it? I mean, after all, there's child pornographers, there's terrorists, there's drug dealers out there, and they use privacy too. So shouldn't the government be able to just violate anyone's privacy that they want to? That's basically what the head of the Senate Intelligence Committee, Richard Burr, has been arguing for in a Wall Street Journal op-ed. We'll continue that story here in moments. Also, Austrian economists like Hoppe and Rothbard have adopted in their writings a position against open borders. Now, this is something that is somewhat divisive amongst libertarians these days. David Hathaway's got a new book out, Immigration, Individual versus National Borders, and it takes apart those arguments against open borders while still supporting the position that an individual property owner has the absolute right to exclude or invite anyone onto their property. You can get your copy of Immigration, Individual versus National Borders through Amazon, and you can purchase it in print or Kindle form. So it's the book by David Hathaway, Immigration, Individual versus National Borders. And if you're going to shop on Amazon, don't forget to shop through shop.freetalklive.com. When you do that, Free Talk Live gets a portion of your purchase price. So again, that's shop.freetalklive.com. Let's go to your calls and thoughts here, then more from Chairman Richard Burr, who wants to violate anyone's privacy as long as the government says they're interested in knowing what you're up to. Let's go to Tom, listening in Missouri first. You're on Free Talk Live with Ian and Darryl. Hello, Tom.
Hello, sir.
Hey there.
Hello, indeed. I admire your program very much. I'll try not to take up too much time.
Thanks, Tom. Go ahead.
Your name is Richard Bird. I love that part. It's the top words I heard in your entire message. So many people say the government this, the government that, the government this, they do this, the government does that. That don't mean that public needs to know names. Don't use the name government, because there's individuals behind all the good and the bad.
Well, it's all bad as far as I'm concerned. I mean, what does a government do that's really good?
I better not say.
They kill people. They're really good at killing people.
If they go.
Does that make you feel awkward? I mean, is that why you're laughing so much? No,
it says of all the U.S. Government employees in Washington, or 90% of them, probably or more, were put on a ship and went out to sea and they sunk. What could we lose?
A good ship.
Thanks for the call, Tom. I appreciate it. Toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. Now, you could argue that the government does things like there's the National Weather Service, there's NASA, there's some of the less offensive things that they do that, you know, maybe more people would support than not, but they're funding those things through the threat of violence. And that's
right.
Ultimately the real problem with government as we know it today.
If the Corporation for Public Broadcasting stopped receiving government funds, I would become a monthly donor to help fund PBS.
But right now you don't, because they do take somewhat 10% of their funding or something like that through taxation.
It's like somewhere between 10 to 15% of the funds come from the federal government through taxation. If they stopped taking that, I would donate.
I actually did donate to one of the public stations in Tampa, and you know, it wouldn't be hard for them to cut off the 10%. Like,
right,
you know, you should be able to hack off 10% of your budget at any given time if you need to tighten your belt or whatever. And so it's like not an impossible task for them to do that. Fire departments, I think a lot of people like the fire department. So there are certainly some, you know, snow clearing. There are certainly some things that the government does today that would need to continue to be done without the coercive monopoly that we know of as the government.
And it's not everywhere that the fire department is a government function. There's a lot of places where the fire department is run completely by volunteers.
Our toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. Let's go to Dave. He's in New Hampshire. Dave, you're on Free Talk Live with Ian and Darryl.
Yeah, I wanted to update you about a right to travel case in New Hampshire. You get, you know, a fair number of calls from people who want to talk about that and whether we're doing anything about it. I guess what I can do about it today is draw a little more attention to what's happening to Dan Stewart. Do you know him?
He's an early mover for the Free State Project. He has been caught for driving while suspended, and I believe is going
numerous
to prison
times.
For it, because in New Hampshire, that's one of the things. New Hampshire's a pretty good place. It's pretty free compared to other states, but there are some areas where it is not very free, and driving without government permission slips tends to result in pretty serious jail time. In this case, he's looking at a prison sentence. He's already in prison. They're just going to sentence him to whatever arbitrary amount of time, which I believe will be a 2-year minimum for where he's at.
State law specifies a 1-year minimum, but it does not specify a maximum.
Dave?
I believe he's at the state prison in Berlin. I think he went in October, and I didn't even hear about it until this week. And it seems like it's one of those things that's just sort of forgotten, and he's forgotten. And I always hate it when that happens. And calling Free Talk Live is a useful means of dealing with that.
You know, I think but to I some extent, Dave, activists need to take some responsibility for their promotions of their activism. So. Let me explain, I guess, a little bit here for our listeners that don't know. The three of us that are on the air right now, Darryl, you and I, and this is Dave Ridley from RidleyReport.com on the line with us. We all moved here to New Hampshire as part of the Free State Project, which is it's essentially a migration, a political migration of libertarians and voluntarists who are converging on this one plot of land, which is New Hampshire, to achieve more freedom in our lifetime. And there's various different ways to go about doing that. Some people who've done freedom to travel activism, which means to basically, you know, go from point A to point B in a car without any kind of government permission slip. That's one of the more common ways it's done. It happens only every so often. There's not a huge amount of people that are doing that here. And of course, usually they're doing it alone. And so when they get busted, then they, you know, they ultimately have to break and pay up at some point if they want to be able to drive without going to
or
prison.
Or sit in jail.
Or go to prison. And it keeps getting worse. Like, the more times you get busted, the worse the sentences are going to be. And as you said, Darryl, this guy Dan had been popped more than a few times. And I think that if you're going to court and you have a legal situation like this, that it behooves you to go ahead and promote your own court date to, you know, I mean, it'd be great if somebody else would pick up that ball for these folks, but that's not happening. So, you know, if you want people to show up at your court date, you need to tell them that you're going to court. You need to tell them when you're going to court. You need to put the news out to the Liberty community that these things are happening and that you want support. There was a guy in this area who got busted for some sort of driving while license suspended, but it wasn't a multitude of busts. It was like just one or something.
Right.
And I'd heard word that he was going to have court, but he hadn't promoted it at all that he was going to have that court, and nobody knew when the court date was. So I don't feel – it's hard for me to feel sad if somebody – is not actively like promoting the fact that they're doing whatever it is they're doing. If you're doing activism in secret, then you shouldn't be surprised when no one shows up to support you, I guess is what I'm saying, Dave.
Well, yeah, and maybe I'm complaining about him just as much as I am complaining about what happened to him. But you know, I guess he's you know, he's facing about a year. I guess the earliest he could get out would be September of next year.
Yeah.
And again, the latest he would get out would be, I guess, 2020. I guess it all depends on good behavior or not. But yeah, I mean, I, you know, it's probably an exaggeration. I shouldn't say I'm complaining about it, because you know, he hasn't done near as much wrong as what the state is doing to him.
Oh, it's absolutely wrong what's happening to him. I mean, it's not that I don't. Stand by, Dave. We'll continue. Freedom to travel. Maybe you've tried some of this. You want to share your experience. It's Free Talk Live.
The final phase of extermination is set to commence now. And as population die-off becomes evident, you know it is the time of punishment in all that is written. The cover for mass die-off is evolution and global warming frauds, also used as false proof of their Christ. They are from the lines that were disinherited 2,000 years ago. Now they claim to be his Christ based upon blood type, DNA, and long lifespan. Go to unveilingthem.com. That's UNVEILINGthem.com.
If you or someone you care about loves outdoor adventure, then check out slingbow.com for some unique holiday gift ideas. That's slingbow.com, where we have some innovative new products for the archer, hunter, or bow fishing enthusiast in your family. Now through January, use the promo code HOLIDAY to get free shipping in the US or Canada. And from all of us at Slingbow Industries, have a safe, joyous, and peaceful holiday season.
If you are successful at what you do, whether you're a doctor, a lawyer, a business owner, or you have a great career, you understand the concept of protecting yourself. Well, are you protecting yourself, your family, and your assets with quality term life insurance? Consider these possible rates. A man age 45, non-tobacco user, could obtain $1 million of coverage for as little as $75 a month. And this rate is fixed for the next 10 years. We specialize in policies of $500,000 and above. A man age 50, non-tobacco user, may be able to obtain $500,000 of coverage for as little as $115 a month. And this rate is fixed for the next 20 years. We have great rates for smokers, too. Call the Term Lifeline now. 800-872-0403. 800-872-0403. 800-872-0403.
How many lawyers does it take to change a light bulb? None. They'd rather keep their clients in the dark. There are too many lawyer jokes to count. However, there are some lawyers with more noble intentions. At the Institute for Justice, we bring the light to our clients. We are a nonprofit public interest law firm with clear values and principles. At IJ, we fight for those whose most basic rights are denied by the government. Visit our website today at ij.org.
Did you know that you can listen to and watch Free Talk Live during our live show 7 days a week from 7 to 10 p.m. Eastern via our studio cam at cam.freetalklive.com? Not only that, but you can also chat with other listeners at the same time. Do I need to mention that both the studio cam and chat room are totally free? Outside of Free Talk Live's live hours, you won't see a cam feed, but we'll hear audio from the Liberty Radio Network. So listen, watch, and chat all free at cam.freetalklive.com. That's cam.freetalklive.com.
Free Press Publications is an independent, alternative media and publishing company founded in June 2009 with the mission of ensuring a free press for the freedom movement and is committed to spreading the message of peace, freedom, love, and liberty. FPP also gives new authors an avenue for publishing freedom-oriented material. FPP brings you daily news and commentary on the website fpp.cc, as well as a daily 5-minute newscast, FPP Radio News, and weekly news, views, and commentary in the FPP Freedom Minute and Peace, Love, Liberty Radio at fppradio.com, and the monthly newspaper FPP News at news.fpp.cc. Find FPP online at fpp.cc. That's fpp.cc, as in Creative Commons.
This is the Liberty Radio Network, broadcasting the latest liberty-oriented audio content 24 hours a day at lrn.fm.
Free Talk Live, you are invited to join us here, whether it's encryption, the ability to protect your files from snooping, whether it's, you know, businesses that are trying to compete with you, or the government that's trying to steal your information. The government now wants to be able to get into your files just by asking Apple or Google or whoever to unencrypt them for them. You can share your thoughts on encryption and the right to privacy, or talk about your right to travel, or at least the theoretical right to travel. You're supposed to have a right to travel. The people who support right to travel activism, and I support it, by the way, the people who support right to travel activism, some of them will argue that the Supreme Court has even ruled that you have a right to travel in the United States. But of course, if you try telling this to a police officer who is pulling you over and you don't have the government permission slip, that's probably not going to go over too well. And further, if you try telling a judge because you've told the police officer and it didn't go over well and you ended up in front of a judge, that's also probably not going to go over too well.
Right.
But our toll-free number, if you've got an experience you want to relate, is 855-450-FREE, 855-450-3733. Also, coming up, the New Hampshire Liberty Forum. It's going to be in less than 2 months now. Starts February 18th through the 21st. It's at the Manchester, New Hampshire Radisson Hotel. You'll get to meet people like Darryl and myself, liberty activists who, some of them have done this right to travel activism, but you can meet all kinds of different activists at the Liberty Forum, folks who've made the move here as part of the Free State Project, and other people who are not necessarily Free State Project participants, like Edward Snowden. He's going to be the keynote speaker. You want to talk about a guy that knows his stuff about privacy and encryption? Edward Snowden recommends PGP if you're going to be encrypting things. He's going to be speaking at the Liberty Forum, but not in person because the government will kidnap him if he shows up inside the United States. So he'll be appearing via a video link, and from what I understand, we'll take questions from the audience. NHLibertyForum.com. Join us. We're going to be broadcasting live from the event. We'll look forward to seeing you there February 18th through the 21st. It's one of the two yearly events that the Free State Project puts on here in New Hampshire to kind of show off what it's like to be here, what it's like to live around hundreds and soon thousands of like-minded, liberty-oriented people who actually care about freedom and are willing to do something about it. NHLibertyForum.com, February 18th through the 21st in Manchester. We'll see you there. Dave is on the line. He's from RidleyReport.com. You're talking about a guy, an early mover, Free State Project participant, Dan, who is now facing a prison term of, I mean, I heard that he was facing a minimum of 2 years on this one, Darryl. Maybe I misheard that. I know that there are one-year punishments for a driving while license suspended.
Right. The statute about habitual offender specifies 1 year.
Is that for the first habitual offender offense, or what if he's gotten his, you know, what if he's already gone to jail for this and this is the second time around? I don't know.
I don't know.
So I know it's pretty serious. Like, this is one of the most ridiculous and serious crimes, I'm putting quotes around that, in New Hampshire. When I was in jail for civil disobedience, there was a guy in there for an entire year because he was driving to work. And it wasn't like he was driving drunk. The guys that were in there for driving drunk were only there for 3 days and 21 days, respectively. The guy that was in there for driving to work without a government permission slip was in there for a solid year. Dave, you're back on with us here from New Hampshire. Go ahead with any other thoughts you want to add in.
Well, I do want to make clear he's not a nobody. I'm not sure he's an early mover. He may have already been here, but he
was
a big part of the Alternatives Expo at the Liberty Forum and Pork Fest that's been going on for almost 10 years. He's more than just someone who happened to be arrested. He's one of us.
Well, I mean, I don't know if I thought he was a Free State Project participant. I didn't know that there was that he might just be a native. But either way, yeah, he's a liberty-minded person. He's an activist.
He took part in the first Keenvention. He was on the secession panel.
But, you know, on the other hand, and again, I feel terrible for the fact that he has to go to jail over this. I don't think anyone should spend time inside a jail cell for driving somewhere safely. And arguably, that's all he was doing, was going from point A to point B without whatever government permission slip. On the other hand, it's not like you couldn't see this one coming, right? The first time you get popped for driving while suspended, it might be a misdemeanor charge, but you're not going to likely spend much, if any, time in jail over the first time.
Right.
So he's been popped multiple times on this, and at some point, the judge will inform you, look, Mr. Dan, if you get busted again for this, it's going to be a habitual offender status.
I've been in court before where numerous people, person after person, with, you know, some driving thing, and the judge will say, just a reminder, if you get charged with this
one more time
in the next X number of months, you will go to jail for a year, habitual offender status.
Yeah, and I don't recall Dan, this character, ever promoting any of his previous arrests or his court dates or anything like that. You know, it seems to me that if you're going to do right-to-travel activism, you should do it with sunlight on the entire process.
Right.
You know, record video of the stop. Record video of the court interactions.
Notify people when you do get stopped, and they can show up and get a second angle on it.
Maybe those things were done, but, you know, we haven't heard about that happening. There's nobody promoting that. In the Grafton area, which is, I believe, where he was living. So, you know, it's I think to some extent he dropped the ball there, because if you're doing right to travel activism, it's your first time in court when you get to try out whatever it is, whatever mumbo jumbo in court that you want to try to throw at the judge to get out of this. Because if it's your right to travel, then you should be standing on that right and you should be making those arguments in court. You're going to likely fail at the district court level, and then you can appeal to the Supreme Court if you want to, if you're really serious about it and trying to prove that you have this right to travel. But it doesn't seem like he did that. It just seemed like he just kept getting busted and then kept driving. And then ultimately, you know it's going to get pretty bad if you don't settle up with the gang. I mean, everybody else that's ever done right to travel activism stops after their first arrest or two, because if they keep going further, it's prison time in New Hampshire. So it's hard to feel too sorry.
I stopped doing it when the police said, if we see you driving again, we will steal your car.
Yeah.
I'm assuming he must know something we don't. I mean, there must be some reason why he didn't promote it. Maybe there's a good reason. And maybe he wasn't doing so much activism when he was driving, but just trying to, earn a living and do his driving. Every time one of us gets arrested, it should be an issue. It should be something that's not swept under the rug.
Well, I guess that would fall on the people that are closest to him. So where's the Grafton activism? Where's the Grafton blog talking about this? Where's the coverage? Where's the video? He's dropped the ball, and the other activists around him who purportedly would be his friends have dropped the ball. So that's why we need more people here who are willing to actually take these things to court and to publicize these matters.
Well, there might be good news for Dan and the other right-to-travel activists, because there's pending legislation that at some point early next year will wind up getting a committee hearing. It's on a constitutional amendment to amend the New Hampshire Constitution to state that all people have a natural and unimpeded right to travel within the state, whether on foot or in their choice of privately owned conveyance. Now, I have no clue what that actually means. Mm. Does that mean that the regulations on requiring a driver's license or vehicle registration will wind up getting thrown out?
That'd be nice.
Probably not, yeah. But it would be nice.
So, Dave, I mean,
I don't see why they would need a CACR to do it. Why, I don't know why they couldn't just have legislation that just repeals whatever law gave the cities the authority to mess with your right to travel.
Well, I don't know if it's the cities. I'm pretty sure it's the state here in New Hampshire that is writing the regulations.
It's a state statute.
Okay, I see what you're saying. Well, whatever law gave the state that power, then to just repeal it.
Dave, thanks for the call. Appreciate your thoughts here tonight. Dave from RidleyReport.com. Great channel on YouTube to go and kind of take a look at some of the things happening here in New Hampshire. Our toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. I mean, look, I wish we had enough activists here to where if somebody gets arrested that there's like a crew of people who could just jump on that arrest and promote it for the person. But it's one of those things where if you don't take the lead on your own, how can you expect somebody else to do it for you?
Right, and you were talking about the guy here locally that had some kind of thing, didn't tell anybody he was in court until after he got out of court.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah, I had court earlier today.
I would have gone. I wanted to see.
Everybody would have gone. Yeah.
Well, I don't know if everybody would have. Some people have to work. They can't go to court.
Right. But the typical people that go to all of the court trials.
We had close to a dozen over a week's time at James Cleveland's trial, and that's on the low side. I mean, some trials have had as many as 30 or 40 attendees if they're well promoted in advance and folks know who the person is. Toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. It's going to get better when we have thousands of people moving here as part of the Free State Project. But, that's going to take some time. It's Free Talk Live.
Every once in a while, you get information that's worth changing your life for. This is one such time. You can save up to and beyond 25% on all purchases at Amazon. You probably heard of Bitcoin and just not thought much about it. You certainly know that you can get competitive pricing at Amazon, But now you can get a 25% discount on nearly everything you need to live. I've just given you a huge raise, and all you have to do is claim it. You go to saveitpurse.com and open an account. Do this right now. Don't wait. Then you fund the account with Bitcoin. You can buy them through expresscoin.com with a check or money order. There are other ways to get Bitcoin, but that's fast, safe, and easy. This information is worth you changing the way you do things. Go to saveitpurse.com right now, get signed up, and cash in on the huge raise I'm offering you. 15 to 25% off of everything at Amazon through saveitpurse.com. It's saveatpurse.com.
Did you know that home break-ins increase more than 100% during the holidays? It takes just 10 seconds for an intruder to kick in your door. But police response to a home alarm system is more than 20 minutes. And intruders are in and out of your home in 5 minutes. Thieves know that you're not home and have presents inside just waiting to be taken. And if you are home, how safe will you feel with an intruder lurking inside with your family? That's why police across the country are recommending you use Door Armor. Proven to withstand the force of a battering ram, Door Armor keeps intruders out. It's easy to install and barely visible, and your Door Armor is guaranteed for life. Go to invasionstopper.com for a very special buy one, get one at half off deal. These savings are for a limited time and only available to GCN listeners. Protect your valuables and loved ones this holiday season. Go to invasionstopper.com now. That's invasionstopper.com.
On Free Talk Live, we're bringing people to the ideas of liberty every day. From wrestling superstars like Glenn Jacobs.
You guys really are having an impact, I believe. Like I said, a lot of where I am now is due to listening to Free Talk Live. You changed my mind on some very important issues years ago.
To random people tuning in on the radio.
I was kind of stuck in the left-right paradigm. I heard your show by chance on a Saturday night. From there, I went on, joined the Free State Project and become an amplifier. So, I mean, that's really the reason why I amp is because I know that if it wasn't for you guys being on as many stations as you are, I never would have found the ideas of liberty.
Your amp will directly change more lives by getting Free Talk Live in front of people looking for talk radio online and on the air. When you amp Free Talk Live, you get perks like access to the AMP only Facebook group and AMP podcast. Visit amp.freetalklive.com.
LRN.fm is proud to announce our official listening apps for Android and iOS devices. Now you can easily tune into our streams anywhere, anytime on your smartphone or tablet. Just visit apps.lrn.fm or search for LRN.fm in the Android or Apple app stores. Please download, rate it 5 stars, then share the link on social media, and let your friends and family know how you're listening to LRN.fm. Download it now, free at apps.lrn.fm. That's apps.lrn.fm.
Radio is the most personal of mediums. I exist right now in your head. If you listen to Free Talk Live regularly, you know me. Free Talk Live is on more than 160 radio stations around the U.S. and has been downloaded on every continent around the world. Hundreds of thousands of listeners with ad packages from $600 a month to $6,000 a month. Imagine what we can do for your business, project, website, or idea. Email me, mark@freetalklive.com.
You can sign up to receive the latest about the Liberty Radio Network via our email updates at updates.lrn.fm. That's updates.lrn.fm.
It's Free Talk Live. You can join us here on the live Saturday edition. Toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. It's the day after Christmas, and Free Talk Live is live throughout the holidays. With you in the studio tonight, you've got Ian.
And Darryl.
And don't forget to join us online over at freetalklive.com. If you like the show and you want to help support Free Talk Live, please become a Free Talk Live amplifier over at amp.freetalklive.com. Many of you may remember Mark, our mostly full-time co-host, who has now left the show. He left at the very end of the show last Saturday night, and he said he wanted more Free Talk Live listeners to become Free Talk Live amplifiers before he'll consider coming back on the air with us. We've had a really great week. There have been more than 45 brand-new ampers signing up. We've had like 8 or 10 people who formerly had amped, who re-amped. We had some current amplifiers who upped their amp. So it's been a really busy week. Thank you to everybody who has signed up thus far. It's pushed us above $3,000 for the first time in a while. So thank you for that. And you can go to amp.freetalklive.com as well to contribute via any major credit card through PayPal, Visa or MasterCard, right on our website. And now Bitcoin. You can contribute via Bitcoin for the first time as of just a few weeks ago. So give it a try over at amp.freetalklive.com, and you'll get perks like access to the AMP-only call-in lines, the AMP-only Facebook group as well, which is very, very popular. Go to amp.freetalklive.com. And if you want to read Mark's first blog post, which is kind of his midweek reflections on what people have been saying about him leaving the show, leaving the on-air side of the show. He's still behind the scenes doing some sales for Free Talk Live. He's our sales manager. But if you want to see what he has to say about that, he's posted that on the Free Talk Live blog. Go to freetalklive.com, click FTL blog there on the front page, and you'll see Mark's post is, I think, about two posts down the page. So that will give you the latest from Mark at freetalklive.com. Just click FTL blog. As we go to Jay, he's on the line in Massachusetts. Go ahead, Jay.
Hey, guys. I wanted to talk about Dave was talking about with the man who was having problems up in Grafton.
The guy who was busted for driving while license suspended, a habitual offender status resulting now in prison time.
Correct. So I was up there last week talking to his close friends, and I had talked to him last summer about this at length. And what his friends had to tell me is that he basically didn't get on top of it. He didn't go to court dates. He kind of just shrugged it off.
Well, that will never work. That is a tactic
came after him.
Yeah, that's a tactic that is doomed to failure. So
absolutely.
I'm just going to ignore them. Yeah. I don't care that they say I've got to go to court.
That is not. I don't qualify that as activism. That's just laziness, and it's not going to result in anything that could possibly be a good thing. I mean, look, court's a scam. There's no doubt about it. I get that. I mean, it's a setup. They're going to win almost every single time. But the only way you can ever possibly win at court, the only way you can reduce the amount of damage that they do to you, is to show up and to do something.
Right.
To not show up, you're just going to get warrants for failure.
There's going
to
be a warrant, and as soon as you wind up getting stopped,
bail's going to get pulled for bail jumping. You might even catch a bail jumping charge. I mean, this could be a really bad thing to do that, and it sounds like it's been bad for him.
And I
it's hard to feel sorry for someone in that situation.
I currently have a warrant in South Carolina, and I know at some point it's going to wind up, you know, coming to bite me in the butt.
Is it a misdemeanor warrant?
No, but okay. Warrants in South Carolina never go away.
Not a felony, though. It is a felony?
No.
Oh, okay. So then it's a minor.
Driving.
So you'll never get extradited for it or anything like that?
Probably not. No. But, you know, like if I wind up getting stopped in the wrong state, then they could wind up holding me for a while trying to figure out what to do with me.
Go ahead, Jay.
Darryl, about your warrant thing in Carolina there, I would be very happy to provide a little assistance with some paperwork to send to the people calling themselves South Carolina. That may remedy the warrant situation. I have actually done that once myself. There was a warrant out for my arrest in Indiana. And
what's the approach there?
Paperwork.
What would the paperwork basically? What would the gist of it be?
The gist of it would be that, well, as long as he didn't hurt anybody or damage any property, the gist would be there's no injured party. That I'm not a United States citizen. I've got some Supreme Court rulings. We'll have to find some South Carolina court rulings. In fact, I have a friend who's very good with South Carolina. And we basically just notify them of their error, their mistake. And it, you know, it is basically just going to be a one-page document that would be sent to the court with a basically return self-addressed stamp envelope for them to respond, stating that they've either canceled the warrant or whatever.
Couldn't hurt. I mean, it couldn't hurt to try it.
Yeah, couldn't hurt.
Right. Hey, Jay, I'll let you get in touch with him off the air about that. Thanks for your call tonight, man. I appreciate it. Toll-free number 855-450-FREE.
Or if Jay just sends the document to the Free Talk Live studio, then
for your signature.
It'll get to me.
Yeah, have you sign and send it out. Toll-free number 855-450-3733. Let's talk to Richard. He's listening in Washington State. You're on Free Talk Live with Ian and Darryl. Hello, Richard.
Yes. How about these? Like California, they're giving driver's license to illegals.
Well, what do you mean by illegal? What's an illegal? What do you mean by that?
Well, people that come across the border without really coming, like my grandparents did.
Yeah, I mean, aren't those people heroes? I mean, shouldn't we be?
Aren't they what?
Heroes. I mean, isn't it heroic to to try not to pay the government?
They're committing civil disobedience, basically.
Yeah, I mean, you don't agree with the government, do you? You think they should be telling people what to do?
I'm 69 years old. I've seen a lot in my life, and I'm tired of all this BS that people, you know, they're coming in here and taking jobs, and we're packing more people in, and they're giving them driver's licenses. What the heck for?
But isn't it kind of a heroic thing?
We don't have the United States anymore. I spent 4 years in Vietnam and 18 months in Vietnam.
You fought for nothing. I'm sorry about that. I'm sorry to hear about that. They took advantage of you.
Well,
that's not very nice of them.
I feel sorry for the guys nowadays, but they joined on their own.
So you were drafted.
A lot of DI friends. Yes, sir.
Yeah. I'm really sorry that happened. I mean, they enslaved you, and that is a wrong thing to do. But just because you have been enslaved should not mean that you should call for other people's enslavement, sir.
I'm not. I don't need. We're losing our country, realistically.
Wait, what? You broke up. What about your country?
We are losing our country.
I don't even know what that means. What does that really mean? What does it mean to have?
I don't know how to explain it to you.
Well,
it's
right,
so
because
easy.
It's meaningless. What does it mean to have a country?
No, we don't have. Pardon?
What does it mean to have a country?
It means to. I can do what I want, pretty much, except break laws. Hell, this president has broken so many laws.
Do you know how many laws there are, sir? What makes you think you aren't breaking laws?
Hey, there's thousands of them, believe me.
Have you ever sped?
I saw the new law that Obamacare. God.
So have you ever sped on the roads?
Have you ever broken the speed limit? Hey, even when I was younger, I drove drunk. But
doesn't that make you an illegal?
I never had a drunk driving.
Did you ever drink underage?
Never got thrown in jail for it.
Did you ever drink underage?
What's that?
Did you ever drink under the age of 21?
Oh, hey, my parents owned a bar.
So we've determined now, sir, that you are also illegal. Are you not?
No, I think statute of limitations has already run out on that.
When was the last time you sped? You broke the speed limit.
I've never gotten a ticket.
I didn't ask you if you got a ticket. So, you broke the law, didn't you?
Well, apparently.
Yeah. So you get to pick and choose the
laws
you break.
But no, I get to pick and choose. Yeah. I want to pick and choose who in the heck is coming in this country.
I see. So it's okay for you to break the law, but other people know.
Driver's licenses that don't belong here.
I think they belong here. I think that anybody who comes to this place should be able to stay here so long as someone's willing to put them up for it.
And I don't see what the big deal is with somebody getting a driver's license. There's a law, statute, whatever you want to call it. There's something on the books.
Wherever other country. Sneak into Mexico and see what they do with you.
It's actually not too hard to sneak into Mexico, from what I understand.
I'm still trying to figure out.
What happens to you.
There's statutes and regulations and whatnot that are being enforced by police that say that if you drive, you have to have a little piece of plastic saying that you know how to drive. So you're saying you don't think anybody from foreign countries that winds up breaking some kind of regulation to get here should have that piece of plastic, so you want them to go to
jail
for not having a driver's license when they're driving down the street.
Kick them out. How about that?
Thanks for the call tonight, Richard. I don't think that violence is going to solve your problems. The toll-free number is 855-450-FREE, 855-450-3733, and violence is all the state knows.
Are your kids spending too much time online? Are they gaming instead of doing homework? Are they on Facebook instead of sleeping? Turn their internet access access on or off when you want for free at webcurfew.com. 100% web-based interface means nothing to download, install, or configure. Webcurfew is free and controls any device using your home network without slowing down your internet. Block all adult web content with the click of a button. Don't let the internet raise your kids. Take back control of how and when your home internet is used for free. Visit webcurfew.com. As a pioneer of the e-commerce movement, Overstock.com is proud to be the first major retailer to accept Bitcoin. Overstock was the first because Patrick Byrne, Overstock's CEO and founder, firmly believes in personal freedom and cryptocurrency. Over the past 16 years, Overstock has furnished over 18 million homes with a diverse line of products to suit everyone's unique styles and preferences. Support Overstock and freedom of choice while enjoying free shipping on orders of 0.211 Bitcoin or more.
When I found the Free State Project, I knew it was the key to achieving liberty in my lifetime. It's awesome to be surrounded by like-minded, freedom-loving activists who've moved here to New Hampshire. From politics to civil disobedience, we have it all. Where I came from, it felt that no matter what I did, liberty was dying. Perhaps you feel the same way? Call 888-377-2515 now to learn more about the Free State Project. That's 888-377-2515 or visit freestateproject.org.
The three most important things you can do for Free Talk Live are, one, share one episode a week on Facebook or in some other social networking site. Two, buy the things you buy online through shop.freetalklive.com. Three, give $5 a month to the AMP program. You likely buy all kinds of things online. Amazon is the largest online retailer. You can get what you need at the same prices with free Super Saver shipping by going to shop.freetalklive.com. Please do your online shopping at shop.freetalklive.com.
You're listening to the live edition of Free Talk Live. Hour number two is next, after the news, here on the Liberty Radio Network at LRN.FM.
From Keene and the Shire, the Liberty Media capital of the world, this is Darryl W. Perry, host of FPP Radio News for Saturday, December 26th, 2015. Silver is trading at $14.38 per ounce. Gold is valued at $1,077 per ounce. And according to BitcoinAverage.com, the average price of Bitcoin is $419. Antiwar.com reports German Foreign Minister Frank-Walter Steinmeier sought to defend his nation's involvement in the war against the Islamic State on Friday, insisting it was necessary for German national security to go abroad and fight, saying it wasn't possible to just hope the Islamic State did not attack Germany. At the same time, Steinmeier sought to downplay the significance of Germany's military involvement, insisting none of the 1,200 troops they are deploying will be boots on the ground fighting the Islamic State directly in Syria or Iraq, nor would any of the planes deployed launch any strikes. Germany had previously sought to avoid the war against the Islamic State, but Parliament approved joining in earlier this month in the wake of the attacks in Paris by the Islamic State. The vote was quickly passed through with comparatively little debate, despite reservations among opposition figures. The big concerns weren't so much the scope of the deployment, however, but rather the lack of any concrete endgame strategy. Some in the German military have also expressed this concern, saying the vague plan is a recipe for escalation.
You can support FPP Radio by shopping online. Whether you're looking for precious metals, bitcoins, or books, you'll find that and more at shop.fppradio.com. Every purchase you make from one of my affiliates at shop.fppradio.com helps fund FPP Radio. Or you can shop directly from FPP with Bitcoin in the Bitcoin store. That's shop.fppradio.com.
UPI reports authorities are investigating a fire that damaged the childhood home of former President Bill Clinton on Friday, and they say indications are it was deliberately set. The blaze broke out around 3:20 a.m. Friday at the two-story home called the William J. Clinton Birthplace in Hope, Arkansas. The historic dwelling, which has National Historic Site status, closed on Thursday and was supposed to reopen on Saturday. Investigators said that so far it appears the blaze was set by an arsonist. Hope Fire Chief Del Glanton told KSLA-TV, "There's just evidence and signs that we do believe it was intentionally set. It will be investigated and handled as a potential arson fire." Fire officials said the home sustained severe damage to its exterior as well as smoke and water damage. One indicator that suggests arson, according to officials, is graffiti on a sidewalk leading up to the house and more graffiti on the doors. Police Chief J.R. Wilson said, "This is a very important structure and house inside the City of Hope. It's got a lot of historical value to it and stuff here, and like I said, it's a really historical piece of property in Hope." Wilson added that there was a strong smell of accelerant.
For nearly 40 years, Roberts & Roberts Brokerage has been a trusted source for buying and selling precious metals like gold and silver. They also take Bitcoin for precious metal purchases and have permanently removed the minimum purchase amount for all orders paid in the digital currency. Call Roberts & Roberts today for knowledgeable advice on buying and selling precious metals and a forward-thinking approach to new technologies. 800-874-9760 or visit online at rrbi.co.
Reuters reports a tornado struck Birmingham, Alabama on Friday, damaging houses, uprooting trees, and injuring at least three people in the state's largest city, according to law enforcement and weather officials. National Weather Service meteorologist Jody Aaron said the twister was confirmed to have touched down in the southwestern portion of town about 5 p.m. Central Time, adding, "There does appear to be some significant damage." Birmingham Police Lieutenant Sean Edwards said at least three people were taken to hospitals for treatment of minor injuries. Edwards said several houses were damaged, but he could provide no further information. Images published online by local media outlets showed lawns scattered with debris from what appears to be homes and some collapsed structures. Alabama has been hit with storms and heavy rain since Wednesday, and the Weather Service issued flash flood warnings around the region on Friday. Emergency declarations were also issued in Mississippi and Tennessee, the two states hardest hit by severe weather on Wednesday. The storm system on Wednesday triggered more than 20 tornadoes in Arkansas, Illinois, Indiana, Mississippi, Tennessee, and Michigan. Six storm-related fatalities were reported in Tennessee, and an 18-year-old woman was killed in Arkansas when a tree crashed into her house. This has been FPP Radio News, online at fppradio.com.
Americans everywhere are enjoying their Sundays after successfully completing Mother's Day in less than 20 minutes this morning. Dads were able to wrap up breakfast in bed by 9:18 a.m., giving them plenty of time to mill about the garage for the rest of the afternoon. While children who spent a minute and a half this morning hugging their mothers are currently out playing street hockey. And after completely fulfilling their Mother's Day obligations with a store-bought card, teens are now free to leave and spend the day with their friends. The moms, who were quickly and efficiently lavished with cards, flowers, assurances of love, and 7 full minutes of family togetherness, praised the competency with which the holiday was carried out.
Oh, it was great. Charles and the kids made me feel completely appreciated, but they ended the holiday before I even got out of bed. Guess I'll go water the plants now.
But before the day-long celebration concluded early this morning, moms had their own job to do, making a brief, obligatory phone call to their own mothers.
This is the Onion News Network.
Free Talk Live.
It is Free Talk Live, the live Saturday edition of the program. Joining you in studio, it's Ian.
And Darryl.
Also, you can join us on the phone lines. The toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. Maybe you want to talk about encryption. Right now, the head of the Senate Intelligence Committee, Chairman Richard Burr, is saying that there needs to be no really way to protect yourself. He says the government should be able to send a request to Apple or Android or Google and have them decrypt all of your encryption.
Or any other tech company.
Right. Or anyone else who's created encryption technology. And so that's the proposal on the table. We haven't really gotten too deep into that. We've been all over the map, talked about immigration as well. So you're welcome to comment here.
Right to travel.
Yeah, right to travel. Whatever happens to be on your mind, 855-450-FREE. Skype in at username lrn.fm. Let's go to Hal is on the line in Texas. Hal, you're on Free Talk Live. Hello, Hal.
Yes.
Hey, you're on the air.
Can you hear me?
Yes, you are on the radio.
Okay. I just wanted to say briefly that this is a scam. And every electronic hardware engineer in the world knows it's a scam. The level, first of all, no real enemy, and I'm also formerly with Army Intelligence, no real enemy in his right mind would use the encryption that's available commercially. I don't want to get into technology, but it has been deliberately sabotaged in order to prevent people from sending secret messages.
Well, then, if that's true, then why is the government making such a big deal about it?
You'd have to ask them, but I'm telling you, it's a farce.
You're claiming there's backdoors in all existing encryption technology?
What I'm telling you is that true encryption for military purposes wouldn't have anything to do with this commercial technology, because it's too commonly known.
Are you saying that PGP is bunk?
I don't even know what PGP is because I don't mess with that stuff.
Well, so how can you claim to be so knowledgeable if you don't even know anything about the topic? I mean, you're just saying that you believe the government.
Can I finish my
statement?
If you want to do real encryption that cannot be broken, get yourself a scientific calculator. You can't use a computer because the high-level programming languages don't allow these functions to be performed. You have to get down to the hardware level. Get yourself a Hewlett-Packard or similar scientific calculator. Look at the logic functions. There's three of them. One of them is called exclusive OR. It's abbreviated XOR. That's how you do it. And there are six cash rewards on the Internet right now with a blogger from Hawaii by the name of Michael Rivero. He has had these six encrypted messages posted with a cash reward for several years because he did it the right way. And nobody has ever claimed those rewards. I don't pay attention to any of this so-called encryption nonsense because it isn't. If I wanted something encrypted,
this sounds paranoid to me.
I guarantee you it would not be broken.
I gotcha. Well, okay, Hal. So basically you have one way that you believe is an effective way to encrypt, and that's fine. Maybe that works, and maybe it works very, very well. The average person isn't going to go ahead and roll their own encryption with a scientific calculator. They're going to choose an encryption technology that is trusted industry-wide and worldwide, like PGP, which is what Edward Snowden, by the way, recommended to folks. For those who don't know, is the guy who came out and revealed all kinds of secrets about the NSA spying on Americans. And Edward Snowden said PGP is the best option for encrypting.
Edward Snowden also said that there are backdoors in a lot of the current technological stuff.
Yeah.
But
you
should only encrypt using a scientific calculator. How do I then send that via email to someone on the other side of the planet?
That's not what I said.
Use a scientific calculator for encryption.
What I said, that the easiest way to demonstrate it is to use a scientific calculator. If you want to send really encrypted messages, you program in machine language. That's the only way you can do it correctly on a computer.
That is not something that is accessible by anyone except people who know what you're talking about, and that is probably a percentage of a percentage of a percentage of the American and world population. But thank you, Hal, for your call tonight.
Want people to use encryption, you have to make it easy, and basically you have to make it idiot-proof.
Well, that's a problem, though. I mean, so I agree with you. The simpler it is, the more people will be able to use it. That's true. But on the other hand, usually the simpler it is, the more likely that there's something wrong with it. To some extent, at least, PGP...
Signal is very easy to use.
It is, no
doubt. When the other person has Signal, it's encrypted.
And Signal is pretty good, from what I understand. PGP is a little harder to use than Signal, but PGP is sort of the standard for encryption from also what I understand. I'm not a machine programmer, so I don't have the ability to go in machine language and construct my own encryption code from scratch, basically, is what it sounds like this guy was arguing for.
I thought he was saying send the message in machine code.
Well, you know, this is where we're both getting lost, Darryl, because you and I are not programmers. We don't really know how to program machine-level code. I did a little bit of programming when I was in high school with Turbo Pascal 5.5, but he's talking about programming the language that the programming languages use, basically.
Right.
You know, turning on ones and zeros at the binary level. And sorry, that's not acceptable for and not even the average person, but for even most computer people. Most computer
right.
people can't do that. Like, I can build a computer from scratch, but I don't have the ability to, well, not from scratch, but from parts. But I don't have the ability. So I'm like more computer illiterate than the average person.
You mean you're more computer literate?
That's what I meant to say. I am more computer literate than the average person. And I still don't have the ability to do what that caller was suggesting.
Right.
So, and also it sounded like he was paranoid as well, basically saying that, well, all these other technologies, they're bunk, they're BS, the government's behind it. I mean, I'm kind of putting words in his mouth saying the government was behind it, but it almost sounded like he was saying that the government has some sort of access to these things. And the way you can prove that that's false is by looking into the code. A lot of this encryption technology is open source.
Right.
And so, all right, I don't know how to program, so I can't really do this. So I have to trust people that I do know who can do this and who have done this to look inside the encryption technology and to look for those back doors, to audit the code, to look and see, is this legitimate or is there something that's wrong with this? And that's what is happening right now, and it's what's been happening. There's actually a program called TrueCrypt, which is one of the world's sort of most renowned forms of encrypting data. It's no longer being developed, unfortunately. There was a weird end to TrueCrypt where the authors of the code actually put up a website update or a blog update saying that people needed to use Microsoft's encryption, which seemed really suspicious considering you wouldn't want to use Microsoft for encryption because they're like working with the feds.
I don't want to use Microsoft for an operating system. Why would I use them for encryption?
It didn't make sense why they would do that, Darryl. So it made it seem like they'd been, I don't know, infiltrated, or they were trying to make it look like, hey, don't trust anything we do at this point. Don't trust our most recent code. And so some people audited the previous TrueCrypt version that had been released prior to them sort of going down the drain, and they found that the TrueCrypt was a solid encryption platform. That was what is my understanding of what had come back. So, you know, you never really know for sure, but when people like Edward Snowden, unless you can do the auditing yourself, but when people like Edward Snowden, who are trusted worldwide for giving you honest information, say PGP is the one thing the NSA has a real tough time with, that they don't like it, that you should use it, that carries some weight with me.
Now, there's a theory that I've read, and I'm only mentioning this because you said that, you know, people like Edward Snowden are trusted. There's a theory that Edward Snowden is, you know, secretly a CIA plant, and whatever documents he released is false information.
Well, the good news is
PGP. And
PGP's
he's encouraging
been
people to use PGP, which is actually, you know, like the most vulnerable.
No.
And all of this other stuff.
PGP's been around and it's been trusted by the security community for a long time, is my understanding. Edward Snowden's just the latest in a series of security experts to say that it's good. But again, unless you can audit the code yourself, you have to choose an expert to trust.
Right.
Or unless you can do what our last caller said and program your own encryption, which probably isn't going to work that well, considering that a lot of these other ones have been programmed for a long time and have been vetted further. Toll-free number 855-450-FREE, plus the guy on the other side needs to know how to decrypt it as well. It's Free Talk Live.
All right, listen up, because this is the most important thing you're going to hear all day. What if I said you could make money flipping houses without any cash, credit, or manual labor? And what if I said you could do it part-time from the comfort of your home? Sound unflippin' believable? Hi, I'm Preston Ealy, and I'm going to prove it by sending you a free copy of my smash hit-selling book, How to Get Rich in Real Estate. It sells online for $19.95, but I'm giving away 5,000 free copies this week. To get one before they're gone, call 1-800-961-8439. I used to be so broke, I had my electricity shut off 9 times, but I figured out a simple way to make money flipping houses without even breaking a sweat. Now I'm living the good life, and so should you. Listen, if you're sick and tired of stressing about money, this book could change your life. Hands down, it's the fastest, easiest way to get started in real estate. Let me prove it. Call right now to find out how to get your free book. When they're gone, they're gone. Call 1-800-961-8439. 1-800-961-8439.
This is a healthcare alert from the Pain Relief Hotline. If you, a family member, or a loved one suffers from knee, back, shoulder, or ankle pain and have Medicare as your primary insurance, we've got great news. You don't have to suffer any longer. you can immediately qualify for a pain-relieving brace at little or no cost to you by calling our 24/7 pain relief hotline at 866-389-0620. Delivery is free and all paperwork is handled for you. If you are on Medicare and have knee, back, shoulder, or ankle pain, don't wait. You can qualify to immediately receive a pain-relieving brace at little or no cost by calling our 24/7 pain hotline now at 866-389-0620. Our representatives are standing by 24/7 to take your call and rush you your pain-relieving brace at little or no cost to you. Shipping is free and all paperwork is handled for you. Just call 866-389-0620. That's 866-389-0620. Again, 866-389-0620.
Every once in a while, you get information that's worth changing your life for. This is one such time. You can save up to and beyond 25% on all purchases at Amazon. You probably heard of Bitcoin and just not thought much about it. You certainly know that you can get competitive pricing at Amazon, but now you can get a 25% discount on nearly everything you need to live. I've just given you a huge raise, and all you have to do is claim it. You go to saveitpurse.com and open an account. Do this right now. Don't wait. Then you fund the account with Bitcoin. I know this sounds unbelievable, but at my house, we saved as much as 45% off of a new item on Amazon. This information is worth you changing the way you do things. Go to saveitpurse.com right now, get signed up, and cash in on the huge raise I'm offering you. 15 to 25% off of everything at Amazon through saveitpurse.com. It's saveatpurse.com.
If you want to know the latest about Free Talk Live before we go on the air, all you need to decide is how you want it delivered. It's your choice. Visit news.freetalklive.com. You can get emailed announcements and participate in contests via our email updates list. Plus, we have a Twitter account that you can follow and a Facebook page where you can become a fan. So visit news.freetalklive.com to get news about Free Talk Live as soon as it's announced and the way you want it delivered at news.freetalklive.com. That's news.freetalklive.com.
This Your Family Today tip is brought to you by Lil Drums. Every bit as fun as a full-size Nestle drumstick cone and definitely cuter. Visit us at drumstick.com. Vacations are all about family time, but you don't have to leave home to have fun. Take one weekend a month and devote it to family activities. Pull out the board games and puzzles, serve up some treats, or have a picnic. Even without leaving home, you'll feel like you've really had some time away. For more tips like these, visit us at parenthood.com/yourfamilytoday.
What's up next? Visit the Liberty Radio Network program guide to find out at shows.lrn.fm. That's shows.lrn.fm.
Yeah! It's Free Talk Live. You can join us on the radio waves. Our toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. We do have Skype as well. Skype username is lrn.fm. You know, most text message marketing services are cumbersome to use. Lots of manual entries required to add and remove subscribers. But with TextFire, your customers can subscribe or unsubscribe to your text messages simply by texting a keyword of your choosing to your number. And by the way, you can use a real local number, not one of those short codes that you might be familiar with in the rest of the text messaging world. You've got unlimited subscriber lists with TextFire, and you can use different lists for different types of customers or even have a staff list, for instance. So if you've got a small business, this is perfect for you, or maybe a church or a civic group. People as or a group as small as 100 or as large as 2,000, anywhere in that range, TextFire can help you out, and they do a great job. Go to TextFire.com, T-X-T-F-Y-R-E. TextFire.com. Free Talk Live listeners like you get your first month free. All you have to do is text FTL, like Free Talk Live, to 877-792-7418. That's code FTL. Text that to 877-792-7418. Or you can call them at 877-792-7418 and mention that you heard about TextFire on Free Talk Live. Again, TextFire.com, T-X-T-F-Y-R-E. com. Right back to your calls and thoughts. Let's go to Loretta in New Jersey. You're on Free Talk Live with Ian and Darryl. Hello, Loretta.
Hi. Hey, I'm calling about immigration a little bit.
Sure.
And also because I'm a little tired of being insulted whenever anybody talks about why we have any laws at all in this country. You try to make them sound like they're idiots because they believe in the laws of the country and everybody breaks them, so why should we even have any? But when it comes to immigration, my grandparents were immigrants. In fact, my daughter is an immigrant, and she's in Norway, of all places, which is a nice socialist country. But my analogy for you, if you don't believe in any immigration laws at all, is when you get home tonight, why don't you just leave the front door to your house wide open so anybody can walk in? And you know why? Because if you leave your house unlocked, everyone will come in and take all your stuff. And basically, everyone in the world would come to the United States if they could. And we're the most generous country in the world. We give more aid and allow more people in than any other country on the planet.
So you're arguing against welfare, not immigration.
No,
She says she likes socialism.
No, you know what it is. I think that people who believe in, I don't think that Americans are so stupid that they everybody who is against illegal immigration is against immigration, period, and they're hard, cold people. Most people just want to have some sort of control over who is coming in the country and when. Now, when my daughter went to Norway, they don't just let you in. You're only allowed to be there for 3 months. They come and they pick you up and escort you out of the country if you overstay your visit. And not only that, you have to have a contract for a job for a specified amount of time to live there unless you're a student.
So what you're saying is the U.S. should be more socialist, more like a socialist country.
No, I'm saying is that you can't say, I'm tired of being insulted as an American because we have some laws.
Do you know how many laws there are in the United States? You couldn't possibly read them all in your lifetime, lady.
Well, you're right. And you know what? I believe in less laws. Frankly,
okay.
I think that every time they write one, they should take one away.
But you, so how can you hold that position then?
Let's just stick to immigration. You said talking about all laws and going all over the map.
Well, that's the problem, though. You said earlier that you wanted to control people, right? You want to control who comes in.
No, I want to control people. Immigration is what I said.
That's controlling people, okay? Because when we're talking about immigration, we're talking about people. So you're saying you want to control people. You shouldn't be surprised, Loretta, when you yourself find yourself controlled by other people's laws.
We already are. And I don't go to another country and expect them for me to make up the laws that I want to respect.
So because somebody has enslaved you, you want to enslave others, right? It's only fair.
Their laws, right?
I don't know if you heard my question, Loretta. You want to control other people.
Hold on, you're both talking, and I can't hear either one of you.
Loretta, I don't think you heard my question earlier. So you want to control other people, and you understand that you yourself are being controlled by the fact that other people want to control you, right?
I think you're using the control word to make it cute and smart. I'm not talking about control. I'm talking about following a law. A law is something that people respect when they go to other people's countries. And when you go to another country, if you say, oh, you're trying to control me, I don't want to follow your law, they throw you in jail and you never get out.
All your precious laws are opinions backed by guns. That's all they are.
No.
Yep.
Laws are something that the people write. In this country, we have a constitution.
That's BS.
And a Congress.
You've never written a law.
We have way too many laws.
You have never written a law, have you, Loretta? Come on, admit it.
Oh, I've read... Yes, I have read a lot of laws.
No,
written.
You said the people write the laws. I'm asking you which laws you wrote.
No, I said write a law. I thought you said read a law. I know what laws are.
Didn't you just say that the people write the laws?
She did say that people write the laws.
Yes, people in Congress write the laws.
Oh, people who aren't you and I then. Why should I respect what those people say?
Because somebody had an election, Ian.
Congress at all. You know, you're right. Don't respect Congress.
No,
don't respect
I
any
don't.
Laws. And you, when you leave work tonight, get in the car and drive as fast as you want and go do whatever you feel.
Yeah, I'll
like
run through some red lights too while I'm at it.
The way you call it, the analogy that you're throwing out there is that anybody who follows the law is being controlled as if there's some big puppeteer up there moving us all. And you're the free one. You don't believe in any laws. And anybody who does, they're just idiots.
You're putting words in my mouth, Loretta. No, you're putting words in my mouth.
We believe in principles, and that principle would be the principle of non-aggression, meaning that we do not initiate force or fraud against other people.
And I believe in natural law. I believe in the law of consequences and actions.
Fraud?
Huh?
Look, you're the one who just said force and fraud. I never said force and fraud. You said that.
I know that's what I said. I said that we abide by a principle. And that principle is the principle of non-aggression, meaning that we do not initiate force or fraud against other people. That's the principle that we live by. I'm not saying that you're advocating for fraud. You're advocating that people follow laws, which are arbitrary things written down by elected officials and backed up by people with guns. And at one time in this country, Loretta, at one time in this country, it was illegal to assist someone in seeking to escape from a slave master. At one time in this country, it was illegal if you came across a slave to not return that person to the person claiming to own that other human being.
What would you have done in that circumstance, Loretta, if you came across an escaped slave?
Well, you know what? If that's how you feel about it, then why don't you go to Africa right now and go to the Middle East and go to all these places?
You'd turn them in, wouldn't you, Loretta?
Go to India.
Hey, Loretta.
Going on today, and you tell them that.
Loretta, we've heard that one a zillion times. Look, would you turn in the escaped slave? Huh?
You know, you're changing the subject again.
You just don't want to answer because you might actually have done it. Thanks for the call tonight. Sometimes you can get these law-abiding people to admit that if they came across an escaped slave back in the 1800s, they would have turned him in because it was the law.
Somebody running a diner that says, yes, I would not have served certain people at my lunch counter.
Our toll-free number is 855-450-FREE, 855-450-3733. It's hard to communicate with people of that particular mindset. It was almost like talking past her.
Right.
The toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. You just obey all the laws you want to. See how that works out for you.
If you or someone you care about loves outdoor adventure, then check out slingbow.com for some unique holiday gift ideas. That's slingbow.com, where we have some innovative new products for the archer, hunter, or bow fishing enthusiast in your family. Now through January, use the promo code HOLIDAY to get free shipping in the U.S. or Canada. And from all of us at Slingbow Industries, have a safe, joyous, and peaceful holiday season. So you've got to take a state construction license exam or certification. Can't decide on what books or what chapters to study? Discover right now how you can eliminate unnecessary books and wasted study time. At contractorexam.com, our study materials zero in on state-required test topics in an effective, multiple-choice format. So whether you're a plumber, electrician, general contractor, or other construction-related trade, contractorexam.com will help get you prepared. Visit us at www.contractorexam.com today.
Money, power, and respect are all yours at CreditSuccessSecretsRevealed.com. Be seen as an industry leader. You can do it. The last application you filled out when it was time to hit submit, did your nerves spike? You didn't get the approval you seek, but there's a better way. We teach you exactly what to place into the right systems the right way the first time so you get approved. Get up to $100,000 in instant business credit. Many people will get cash on the spot. Use those two tools in your new corporate credit engine so you can walk into the bank and get your project funded today. It's all about today at CreditSuccessSecretsRevealed.com. Credit Success Secrets Revealed is explosive and ignites instant results. Dial 1-800-707-8719. That's 1-800-707-8719. 1-800-707-8719. Or just go to CreditSuccessSecretsRevealed.com.
Silver and gold, how do you measure its worth? Just by the pleasure it gives here on earth.
Roberts and Roberts Brokerage hopes you have a happy holiday season and a prosperous 2016. We're available 24/7 at rrbi.co or call 800-874-9760.
Here's a chance to do a little activism while you're cruising Facebook, Twitter, or Google+. Between the LOL cats, the recipes, the hot girls, and the inspirational sunrise memes, Free Talk Live's posts pass by your newsfeed. Like them. Comment. It gives us more exposure. If you don't see our posts, click like at facebook.freetalklive.com and then hover over it to click get notifications. It's an easy way to spread the ideas of liberty a bit further. I know you're busy, but you can spare that tenth of a calorie it takes to click on something. Facebook.freetalklive.com.
Understanding your credit score is the first step towards managing and improving it. This is Charlie Sundstrom with your Van Dyke Mortgage Minute.
The most influential component of your credit score is your payment history. Almost equally as important is the amount you owe on credit accounts. Also impacting your score, but to a lesser degree, are the length of time you've utilized your credit, the number of new accounts, credit inquiries, and your various types of credit accounts. To help achieve or maintain a healthy credit score, have a system set up to assure your bills are always paid on time. Don't max out your cards. It's better to have a high credit limit with a low balance. Never close old accounts. The age of these can actually help your credit score. But don't be afraid to use your credit. You need several accounts in order to have a credit score. Just keep the corresponding payments within your means. For your mortgage pre-approval and refi needs, start by visiting VanDykeMortgage.com.
Corporate NMLS 3035. Van Dyke Mortgage is an equal housing lender. Charlie Sundstrom, NMLS 134251.
If you enjoy LRN.FM, please contribute to your favorite shows via their websites and become an amplifier at amp.lrn.fm. That's amp.lrn.fm.
Join us here on the Radio Waves, live Saturday edition, continuing here with Ian in studio.
And Darryl.
You can also join us toll-free at 855-450-FREE, 855-450-3733. Encryption, that is one of the topics on the table, but it's ended up moving into immigration as well. And the law, this reverence for the law, these words that men and women who you don't even know write down on pieces of paper. Sometimes you voted for them, but most of the time you probably didn't. And somehow that means that you have to do what they say because they've written it down. Well, it's actually the men with guns, of course, that try to ensure that you do what those laws say. And of course, some people can, kind of avoid being punished if they're politically connected or they know the sheriff or whatever. So we all know the laws really don't apply evenly amongst the populace, like especially if you are the sheriff or you're one of the police. You know, the laws very rarely seem to apply to those people. They get away with committing murder and rape and arson and things like that.
Or if you're related very closely to a judge.
That usually helps as well.
Or if you are a judge.
So, and then we can look back in the past, as you did a moment ago, Darryl, pointing out that some laws that did exist in the past do not exist now. Like, for instance, the laws that prohibit that basically made it illegal to assist runaway slaves.
The Fugitive Slave Acts.
Yeah. And there were people who disobeyed those laws. And I say rightfully so. I think that good people should disobey bad laws.
Yes.
And that ultimately, juries should also reject bad laws as well. So when
and one thing that most people forget is the segregation that happened in the southern United States up until like the mid-1960s. That wasn't just racist business owners. It was the law. You had to, because some group of men and women, mostly men at that time, that were elected officials, wrote some stuff down and said, you must do this. You are prohibited from serving whites and quote-unquote coloreds in the same business.
And because that was legal, right? It was they made that legal. That doesn't mean that it's right, does it? Just because something has been made legal doesn't mean it's right. Just because something has been made illegal doesn't mean that it's wrong.
Right.
And there's so plenty of examples of this in history, and still plenty of it today, like the fact that in some places having a certain plant is legal, like in Colorado and Washington State, now Alaska as well, and Oregon, I believe.
Oregon.
It's legal to have
most of Washington, D.C.
Yep, that's correct. It's legal to have the plant known as cannabis on your body. But if you cross an imaginary line into one of the other states, then that same plant in that same pocket becomes a it could be a felony. It could be a misdemeanor, depending on the state government there. So was
and
it
the
right,
quantity.
Was it right in Oregon and then all of a sudden wrong in,
Idaho,
Utah or something like that? So you tell me. The toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. Let's go to the phones and to the fun. Frankie is in South Carolina. You're on Free Talk Live. Hello, Frankie.
Hey, what's going on, guys?
First
of all, as a black guy, if I got caught by that lady that was on the phone before, I would hope she would return me. because, my God, I probably would hang my damn self if I had to listen to her any longer.
I heard you.
Anyway, sorry about the curse word.
No, you're good.
Anyway, I was calling about one or two issues. I can't for the life of me, as an African-American, understand any minority group that supports Donald Trump. I know it's off topic, but it's basically on his immigration stance, that we should send everybody back to Mexico. But really, the bigger issue with me is why the media we have, when it's all closely defined as a liberal media and blah, 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 no one does any investigation about the real Donald Trump. I'm from New York. I'm a native New Yorker. I grew up with a man all across the headlines. He said some really derogatory things his entire life. I'm 35, so he's been saying that as long as I've been living. Where are those statements? Where are those quotes? Where are his business dealings with Saudi Arabia, his business dealings with China, that he just called an imperialist nation and we should get rid of it? Listen, how much business does he does with Carlos Slim, which is the, you know, one of the wealthiest men in Mexico? You know, those business dealings are never brought up in the New York Times, never brought up in the so-called liberal media. I'm not understanding for the life of me who supports this guy.
I think most of the people that support Donald Trump are people that are secretly racist or outright racist, because I've actually had conversations with people where they say, well, Donald Trump says a lot of what I'm thinking. And I said, a lot of what Donald Trump says is racist. And they say, well, somebody recently told me when I said blah, 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 that I might be racist. And I'm thinking, yes, yes, you are.
Oh, God.
Yeah, and it's actually funny that you, I guess it all kind of intertwines, but his slogan is make America great again. I'm like, well, hold on. It's funny you brought up slavery earlier, because that's what I thought about when when I heard his slogan, make America great again. Well, at what America are we trying to go back to? He never actually gets to that point. Are we trying to get back to the Reagan America? Are we trying to get back to the Clinton America? Or we want to go back to Abraham Lincoln's America?
People idealize the 1950s and think that the world was as depicted in the Andy Griffith Show.
That's right.
It wasn't?
That's right.
Now, there was segregation back then, too, wasn't there?
Yes.
In the 1950s. I think you're right, Frankie. That's an important question to ask is, you know, when people are hearkening back to some previous time, is which time were you hearkening back to, and why were you hearkening back to that time? Because you go far enough back, then blacks were three-fifths of a man, you know, back in the
Correct.
Constitutional days. Certainly, I wouldn't want to be going back to that.
And I know it, I don't mean to cut you off, brother, but this is my last topic. But as far as African-Americans, being an African-American and, you know, being very supportive of my people, this Black Lives Matter movement, while I agree with about 5% of what they say, I can't for the life of me don't understand why, you know, our so-called Negro leaders, as Malcolm X used to call them, such as, you know, Sharpton and Jesse Jackson, I don't understand why they literally keep dodging the question of black-on-black violence. Now, it may be wrong, you know, and it is wrong that, you know, a young brother gets killed by an officer, you know, but what right does that give our youth to keep having that pants hanging off their behind, keep using the N-word to loot and pillage their own community because they're angry at the... Listen, you know how many times I didn't got stopped by the police? I didn't got arrested for things that I've never done. Now, I served my country for 12 years, and I was still arrested. I literally just retired from the service, and I was on my way home from finishing all my paperwork. I got pulled over, and I got arrested for suspicion of drunken driving. Now, I didn't have anything to drink but orange juice. It didn't matter.
Suspicion of driving while black sounds like that to me.
Just out of curiosity, are you near Myrtle Beach?
Yeah, I'm in Conway.
Okay, yeah. I used to live in Myrtle Beach, and I remember when the mayor of Atlantic Beach, which is a tiny little like 4-square block town right near Myrtle Beach, she got stopped in Myrtle Beach, blew a 0.00, and was still convicted of drunk driving.
God. Frankie, thanks for your call tonight, man. I do appreciate hearing from you tonight. Our toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. Let's talk to Diane. She's in Michigan. You're on Free Talk Live. Hello, Diane.
Really? Am I on?
You sure are. Go ahead.
Okay. Well, I've been listening to your show for a few months now, and I like it because it's making me think.
Cool.
And, you know, giving me a different... It's kind of like moving my brains around, making me think and force, like, to think things through.
Good, good. I want you to continue with that line of thought here. You can tell us what you were calling about in moments. More with Diane. Your calls and thoughts are welcome here. 855-450-FREE. It's the live Saturday edition of Free Talk Live. 855-450-3733. Join us.
I was coming out of the hardware store when I saw him. An old man, late 70s, hunched over in the freezing rain. No hat on his head, limping across that slippery parking lot and pushing a row of shopping carts toward the cart corral. It's heartbreaking. Millions of hardworking Americans simply don't have enough money to retire, so they just keep working and working and working until it's too late. Hi, I'm Chad Stubbs, president and CEO of Power Trader, and I believe that's just plain wrong. That's why I'm now distributing to the public absolutely free copies of Power Trader's game-changing book on how regular folks can make the money they need to retire fast. For your free copy, call 1-800-771-6706. Don't let the lack of money rob you of your retirement. Call now for details and get your free copy of this book before it's too late. 1-800-771-6706. But hurry while supplies last. 1-800-771-6706. 1-800-771-6706.
We've had an amazing year here at Supernatural Silver. We've truly enjoyed the fantastic response from thousands of people as they've tried our extraordinary product, and we're thrilled at the life-changing results people have. Our company email is continually full of happy, satisfied customers who thank us for the help they've received from Supernatural Silver. This holiday season, as you think of gifts to give your loved ones, consider giving Supernatural Silver, a gift that can help provide good health and wellness, a gift that can change lives and make a real difference. In a world where we are constantly exposed to dangerous health threats, give yourself and your loved ones a fighting chance. Give Supernatural Silver. Go to supernaturalsilver.com and use the promo code HOLIDAY2015 for 20% off. And this holiday season, we wish you and yours the blessings of peace and good health from all of us here at supernaturalsilver.com.
Retail giant CVS is gearing up for floods of customers seeking the perfect meaningless piece of crap for their office gift swap. The company is making no secret that when it comes to wasting the obligatory $20 on a useless electronic dartboard or pretzel maker for someone you couldn't care less about, CVS is your best option.
Our incredible selection of worthless shit is just the thing that nobody wants. We guarantee you'll find nothing personal or unique in our store.
The company is offering massive discounts on otherwise unsellable items for holiday parties you don't even want to go to, like the $12 decorative lantern, which is expected to be a big hit with customers who grab the first thing they see when they walk in the store.
I really wanted to get something that said, I don't care about any of you people and I didn't put any effort into this.
CVS also has shitty Hanukkah gifts for coworkers who you think might be Jewish, like candles and those little plastic net bags full of chocolate money.
This is the Onion News Network.
So you've heard all 3 hours of the latest episode of Free Talk Live, and you're still hungry for liberty-oriented audio content? Did you know that we have another 24/7 audio stream at LRN.fm? The Liberty Radio Network airs the latest episodes of some of the best liberty-oriented podcasts on the internet around the clock. In addition to recorded content, you'll also hear live shows like Free Talk Live, originating from our Keene, New Hampshire studio. So listen anytime at LRN.fm. That's LRN.fm.
Are you a political activist who does things that the government might not like? Then this free ebook may save your life. Rats is your guide to protecting yourself against snitches, informers, informants, agents provocateur, narcs, finks, and similar vermin. Rats was written by OG libertarian Claire Wolf. Rats is a short book, easy to read, and available free in many formats. Download Rats free at rats-nosnitch.com. That's rats-nosnitch.com.
You can watch the LRN Studio Cam and chat with other listeners anytime at cam.lrn.fm. That's cam.lrn.fm.
It's Free Talk Live, live Saturday show. You may join us here toll-free, 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. If you could save 20% on every purchase you make from here on out at Amazon, would you? Would
yes.
you choose to do that? I say yes as well, Darryl, and that's why I've been using SaveItPurse.com for almost an entire year now. I've spent, I don't know how much there, but I bought like 26 purchases. It's been several hundred dollars that I've spent, and I've saved a few hundred bucks as well, because I've saved at least 20% every time, sometimes as high as 30 or even 45%. That's my peak, is 45%. Some have gotten 50% off through SaveItPurse.com. The key is, the catch, if you will, is that you have to use Bitcoin to get these amazing discounts. So start at SaveItPurse.com, SaveATPurse, SaveAtPurse.com, and start saving big time on Amazon, because why wouldn't you want to do that? Let's go back to Diane. She is back with us here on Free Talk Live, saying that you've enjoyed listening to Free Talk Live over the last few months, that it's gotten you to think about things. Go ahead, Diane.
Okay. Thank you. Well, I'm just wondering for, got a question for people like myself that are wanting to dig a little bit more to understand what you're talking about. Are there any books or pamphlets available? What do you suggest?
There are actually a lot of good books, and I happen to own a publishing company, and I publish some of them. So I would highly recommend The Law by Frederick Bastiat. I would also recommend, if you want to sort of delve in a little deeper, would recommend No Treason by Lysander Spooner. And
these are older books. I tend to not recommend older books simply because sometimes they're written in a language that can be hard to digest these days.
Okay.
I mean, if you're good with old style language, then those two books are fine books. If you want something that's more modern, I recommend Healing Our World by Dr. Mary Ruart. It's now in its, I believe, fourth edition.
Fourth edition.
It just came out this year, the new fourth edition of that book, and it's available, of course, through Amazon. And
she also has, Dr. Ruart has a book, Short Answers to Tough Questions, which is a very good book, and you know, it's one that you can pick up and just flip through at your leisure. It's not something that you would necessarily read from cover to cover.
Right. Okay.
There
that
you go.
Good.
Yeah, I hope that helps.
Okay.
And by the way, Healing Our World, there's the original version of that's available free online. So if you go to her website,
Ruart.org.
Ruart.com. But either way, you can actually go, I think you can go to books.freetalklive.com, and it'll take you to a page with some useful books like that on it that you can actually download for free. There's all kinds of information about libertarianism out there, but I think Mary Ruart's Healing Our World is a good one because it's written recently, it's written in a more conversational style, and it's loaded with facts, and it's cited as well. So all the claims that she makes, she always has a little citation next to it where you can go and you can dig in and read what she was, you know, where she was getting that information from. Anything else you want to share tonight,
okay,
Diane?
Sure. Just a little information about the Free State Project and possibly how it relates to, or is it, maybe that's a question, maybe not a statement, to Liberland.
Liberland.
Okay. I heard about it once, and then I go, like, wow, like a new country? What is going on with this?
Let's explain Liberland for our listeners who don't know what that is, because most of them probably don't. Liberland is a plot of land between Croatia and Serbia. It is approximately three square mile area, basically swampland in the, is it the Danube?
Off the Danube.
Yeah. So, you know, it's not a particularly great piece of land, and it has been sort of no man's land for a long time, wherein there's technically no country that claims it.
So there's this group of people, the Liberlanders, if you will, who have gone in and they've sunk their flag into the swamp there, and they've claimed that land as Liberland, and they are trying to build their own country. Unfortunately, the Croatian government doesn't seem to appreciate that, and they've been arresting the Liberlanders when they've been trying to actually go onto this particular plot of land. So it has been a rocky road, to say the least, for the folks in Liberland, but I'm excited by it. I think it's a great idea, and I wish them the best of luck with their project. The Free State Project is a little bit different, a lot different. Okay. The Free State Project is the idea of migrating libertarians and voluntarists, people who love the ideas of liberty, and of course, liberty being, you know, your freedom to live your life how you want, so long as you don't hurt somebody else in the process, basically. But the idea being to let's concentrate people in this one place, this one geographic area. New Hampshire was chosen out of a vote of 10 potential candidate states all within the United States. New Hampshire won overwhelmingly back in 2003, and ever since, people have been moving there. So unlike Liberland, where no one actually lives in Liberland, we've had over 1,500 people move here to New Hampshire as part of the Free State Project. There are now over 18,000 people who are pledged to move to New Hampshire as part of the Free State Project. Once the Free State Project reaches 20,000, there'll be a five-year window of time where those 20,000 folks have to move here. So Liberland's more of like an idea for the future. The Free State Project is something that's happening now. There are people who've already moved, and there are thousands more who are going to move, and they've already had a tremendous impact here inside the state. Free Staters have been called the single greatest threat to the state by people who love the government, and so we're an actual threat to the state, which I think is a good thing. And you can go to freestateproject.org to learn more. Diane, thanks for your call tonight. I appreciate it. Our toll-free number here is 855-450-FREE.
And I've got one more book that I definitely want to recommend. It's my most recent book, and it's actually my memoir of how I came to the ideas of liberty from being basically a conservative Christian. And that book is A Rebel's Journey, My Path to Liberty. It's a very short book. You could sit down and read it in maybe 2 hours.
And one could order that through your website, which is fpp.cc.
Also could order it through Amazon.
Oh, yes.
Using the affiliate link at shop.freetalklive.com.
Because you only take Bitcoin on your website, right?
I only take Bitcoin. Or if they want to use Bitcoin, they could get an even bigger saving by going through Purse and getting probably up to 20%, 25%, 30%.
So the book was A Rebel's Journey.
A Rebel's Journey, My Path to Liberty.
Over at Amazon by Darryl W. Perry.
Yes.
Our toll-free number, again, is 855-450-FREE. We're big fans of the Free State Project. We moved here to New Hampshire as part of the Free State Project. Darryl, you moved from Texas. I moved from Florida.
I'm mover 746.
I'm mover 420 or something like that. Well,
you're in-state number 420. And then they realized, oh, wait a second, we were giving all of these people mover numbers and forgot that there were 100 or 200 and something people in the state before people started moving.
What happened there was the Free State Project had this vote that I mentioned earlier where there were 10 states from which to choose. And so obviously some people already lived in those 10 states. And so the people who already lived in New Hampshire were already in state. They obviously didn't have to move when New Hampshire won. And New Hampshire won pretty solidly, because there's a lot of great reasons why New Hampshire won, and I would recommend you check out the 101 Reasons Liberty Lives in New Hampshire movie. It's an hour-long documentary film that anyone can go and watch for free at 101reasonsfilm.com, because books aren't for everyone, and 101reasonsfilm.com is a great way to go and check out why New Hampshire is the greatest place for liberty already and is only going to be better after thousands more Free State Project participants move here. Byron is in Indianapolis listening to WIBC-FM. Hello, Byron.
Hi, how are you? Okay.
Welcome.
I'm kind of nervous. I've never called. I've listened to you guys a few times.
Don't worry. It's just us here. No one else is listening right now.
Oh, I wish that was true. Okay. No, not necessarily. My question is, you're going to have some sort of cultural paradigm, aren't you, in this thing that you want to start, the free land or something?
You're talking about the Free State Project?
Free State Project. Isn't there going to be some type of paradigm that makes the rules and says everybody has to do this, that, and the other, or there's some kind of penalty?
Well, I can't speak for everybody.
Does anything go? Like garbage anywhere?
I can't speak for everybody, but generally libertarians have a high respect for property rights. And so, no, you would not be able to just throw garbage everywhere because then you'd be polluting somebody else's property.
Okay, well, then what about people that need medicine? And things like that. How
that's
are you
why
going
charity
to change
exists.
Things like that, medicine.
So, you know, some of the things that government does today, other people could do on a consensual basis, like helping people in need, helping poor people, helping homeless people, helping sick people. All of those things can be done on a consensual basis through mutual aid societies.
And right now, there are a lot of regulations that prevent people from providing that charity.
But what about lawsuits? Say, for example, somebody comes to you in a sincere plea for like a treatment of some type, a medication of some type, and it goes bad, and then there's a lawsuit. How are you going to handle lawsuits? Who would they be handed over to?
These are pretty good questions, and they deserve more detailed answers. There's a great book out there called The Market for Liberty that talks about how things like the justice system, the court system, could be done without a government monopoly. I mean, most people know that monopolies are bad things, but yet they accept a monopoly control over courts and monopoly control over things like protection services and fire protection. And we're just saying open that up to competition. Let it be done on a consensual basis and don't force everyone to use the same solution. Thanks, Byron. There's more coming up on Free Talk Live.
Are your kids spending too much time online? Are they gaming instead of doing homework? Are they on Facebook instead of sleeping? Turn their internet access on or off when you want for free at webcurfew.com. 100% web-based interface means nothing to download, install, or configure. Webcurfew is free and controls any device using your home network without slowing down your internet. Block all adult web content with the click of a button. Don't let the internet raise your kids. Take back control of how and when your home internet is used for free. Visit webcurfew.com. As a pioneer of the e-commerce movement, Overstock.com is proud to be the first major retailer to accept Bitcoin. Overstock was the first because Patrick Byrne, Overstock's CEO and founder, firmly believes in personal freedom and cryptocurrency. Over the past 16 years, Overstock has furnished over 18 million homes with a diverse line of products to suit everyone's unique styles and preferences. Support Overstock and freedom of choice while enjoying free shipping on orders of 0.211 Bitcoin or more.
If you want to move to the free state and you're looking for some real estate.
Oof, I think we've all had enough of that jingle, don't you? If you're going to invest in property in New Hampshire, it just makes sense to support a liberty-friendly realtor. Call Mark Warden of Team Porcupine Real Estate for investment property or rentals in the free state, or visit his website. Come on, you know it.
PorcupineRealEstate.com. LRN.fm is proud to announce our official listening apps for Android and iOS devices. Now you can easily tune into our streams anywhere, anytime on your smartphone or tablet. Just visit apps.lrn.fm or search for LRN.fm in the Android or Apple app stores. Please download, rate it 5 stars, then share the link on social media, and let your friends and family know how you're listening to LRN.fm. Download it now, free, at apps.lrn.fm. That's apps.lrn.fm.
You're listening to the live edition of Free Talk Live. Hour number 3 is next after the news here on the Liberty Radio Network at LRN.fm.
From Keene and the Shire, the Liberty Media capital of the world, this is Darryl W. Perry, host of FPP Radio News for Saturday, December 26th, 2015. Silver is trading at $14.38 per ounce. Gold is valued at $1,077 per ounce. And according to BitcoinAverage.com, the average price of Bitcoin is $419. Antiwar.com reports German Foreign Minister Frank-Walter Steinmeier sought to defend his nation's involvement in the war against the Islamic State on Friday, insisting it was necessary for German national security to go abroad and fight, saying it wasn't possible to just hope the Islamic State did not attack Germany. At the same time, Steinmeier sought to downplay the significance of Germany's military involvement, insisting none of the 1,200 troops they are deploying will be boots on the ground fighting the Islamic State directly in Syria or Iraq, nor would any of the planes deployed launch any strikes. Germany had previously sought to avoid the war against the Islamic State, but Parliament approved joining in earlier this month in the wake of the attacks in Paris by the Islamic State. The vote was quickly passed through with comparatively little debate, despite reservations among opposition figures. The big concerns weren't so much the scope of the deployment, however, but rather the lack of any concrete endgame strategy. Some in the German military have also expressed this concern, saying the vague plan is a recipe for escalation.
You can support FPP Radio by shopping online. Whether you're looking for precious metals, bitcoins, or books, you'll find that and more at shop.fppradio.com. Every purchase you make from one of my affiliates at shop.fppradio.com helps fund FPP Radio. Or you can shop directly from FPP with Bitcoin in the Bitcoin store. That's shop.fppradio.com.
UPI reports authorities are investigating a fire that damaged the childhood home of former President Bill Clinton on Friday, and they say indications are it was deliberately set. The blaze broke out around 3:20 a.m. Friday at the two-story home called the William J. Clinton Birthplace in Hope, Arkansas. The historic dwelling, which has National Historic Site status, closed on Thursday and was supposed to reopen on Saturday. Investigators said that so far it appears the blaze was set by an arsonist. Hope Fire Chief Del Glanton told KSLA-TV, "There's just evidence and signs that we do believe it was intentionally set. It will be investigated and handled as a potential arson fire." Fire officials said the home sustained severe damage to its exterior as well as smoke and water damage. One indicator that suggests arson, according to officials, is graffiti on a sidewalk leading up to the house and more graffiti on the doors. Police Chief J.R. Wilson said, "This is a very important structure and house inside the city of Hope. It's got a lot of historical value to it and stuff here, and like I said, it's a really historical piece of property in Hope." Wilson added that there was a strong smell of accelerant.
For nearly 40 years, Roberts & Roberts Brokerage has been a trusted source for buying and selling precious metals like gold and silver. They also take Bitcoin for precious metal purchases and have permanently removed the minimum purchase amount for all orders paid in the digital currency. Call Roberts & Roberts today for knowledgeable advice on buying and selling precious metals and a forward-thinking approach to new technologies. 800-874-9760 or visit online at rrbi.co.
Reuters reports a tornado struck Birmingham, Alabama on Friday, damaging houses, uprooting trees, and injuring at least three people in the state's largest city, according to law enforcement and weather officials. National Weather Service meteorologist Jody Aaron said the twister was confirmed to have touched down in the southwestern portion of town about 5 p.m. Central Time, adding, "There does appear to be some significant damage." Birmingham Police Lieutenant Sean Edwards said at least three people were taken to hospitals for treatment of minor injuries. Edwards said several houses were damaged, but he could provide no further information. Images published online by local media outlets showed lawns scattered with debris from what appears to be homes and some collapsed structures. Alabama has been hit with storms and heavy rain since Wednesday, and the Weather Service issued flash flood warnings around the region on Friday. Emergency declarations were also issued in Mississippi and Tennessee, the two states hardest hit by severe weather on Wednesday. The storm system on Wednesday triggered more than 20 tornadoes in Arkansas, Illinois, Indiana, Mississippi, Tennessee, and Michigan. Six storm-related fatalities were reported in Tennessee, and an 18-year-old woman was killed in Arkansas when a tree crashed into her house. This has been FPP Radio News, online at fppradio.com.
According to a study released Thursday by the Princeton University Department of Biology, this local two-year-old woodland chipmunk has crafted a far more secure and dependable plan for the future than 8 out of 10 Americans. Reporters spoke to citizens to get their view on the study.
Clearly, this chipmunk is pretty impressive. I mean, he wakes up every morning and says, "I need to collect acorns and berries for the winter." He sets goals for himself and he gets it done.
He has to make a burrow in a tree stump. That's exactly what he does. He doesn't pause and have a snack and lay around for a few hours.
Out of nearly 40 separate interviews with Americans, 33 told reporters they were very impressed by the chipmunk's continued display of foresight, personal responsibility, and pragmatic decision-making when considering his own future.
He's preparing for winter, he's building a home, and he's trying to get enough nutrients to make it throughout the rest of the day. All this while being worried about maybe getting eaten by a wolf or an owl or something. Earlier this week, the electricity went off in my home because I forgot to pay my bill. It's the second time this year.
This is the Onion News Network.
It's Free Talk Live. You can join us here as we launch into the third hour of the program. Our number is 855-450-FREE. Live Saturday edition with you tonight. It's Ian.
And Darryl.
855-450-3733. We also have Skype, so Skype on in if you want, at username lrn.fm. Let's go to your phone calls and thoughts. We can come back around to the discussion about your privacy. The government doesn't want you to be able to have privacy is basically the short version of the story. But we can get back into that a little deeper here in moments. First, let's go to Tom in Nashua, New Hampshire, listening to WSMN. Hello, Tom.
Yeah, it's about the Islamic State. When I put Governor Chris Christie on the spot during a campaign stop in Pelham, New Hampshire, it was like, what are you going to do to discontinue the provocations that have given rise to the that have incited the rise of violent Islamic jihadism? And let's face it, that war in Iraq was started just so Vice President Cheney's friends at Halliburton could make money off the oil.
And it's almost undeniable that ISIS came out of the invasion of Iraq and Afghanistan, right? That basically they displaced certain elements that ultimately turned into ISIS.
And what he doesn't want to grasp, I guess, is that these people, you know, it's like each one of them is a distinct individual with a distinct set of experiences, grievances, and personal advisors. And when you do all this stuff, I mean, meddling in the affairs of foreign countries, all the different provocations, letting the state, propping up the state of Israel and then letting her get away with whatever she wants and such things, these anger individuals, and that anger impels them to join the Islamic State. So he is right about there is no reasoning with the Islamic State itself. They are totally crazy. They want to destroy everybody who isn't they. And that much is true. But what he's not grasping is that there's a reason why individuals sign up. And therein lies the difference, is that you're getting, driving more people to the Islamic State by, you know, through these provocations. You're not going to get the Pope to be pro-abortion no matter what, but there's a reason why people become Catholics. There's no dealing with the Islamic State about, you know, how about we leave you alone and you leave us alone. There's no dealing with them because they're totally fried, but there's a reason why their ideology resonates with so many people.
But leaving them alone is not being proposed by any of the Republican or Democratic Party presidential candidates.
No, of course not, because that wouldn't benefit the government. I mean, the war is the health of the state. They all want the government to be at war because then that gives them the excuse to invade more people's privacy and take more people's money and send more of it to their buddies in the military-industrial complex. Tom, thanks for the call tonight. I appreciate it. And, you know, he's right. I mean, the U.S. government meddling in other countries for decades has resulted in what we've got, which is these people who want to kill folks inside the United States.
Right. And then you've got, you know, people in the U.S. military that just want to kill, quote unquote, them because they hate us.
Whatever that means. And really, some of them know, you know, we can't say what everyone believes, but some are certainly well-informed enough to know that it's the U.S. government that's at fault, not the American people. Now, certainly, Americans, by and large, average folks, are going to pay the consequences.
Right.
Because when suicide bombings happen, they're very rarely going to be targeted only at government buildings, as we saw during the 9/11 attacks, for instance.
Or even the attacks in Paris.
Exactly. And so, you know, for Americans who think that they can just go ahead and bomb other countries and kill people around the globe and think that there's going to be no consequence for it, there's always going to be some sort of consequence for it. And in fact, I'm surprised there haven't been more, really. I mean, it's a testament to how safe America is, the fact that there aren't suicide bombings on a weekly basis here, or even a monthly, or barely even a yearly basis. I mean, we don't have hardly anything as far as terror strikes are concerned,
right,
inside the United States, despite the constant bombing, despite the constant murder on the part of the U.S. military in the Middle East. Really, there should be a lot more consequences, but there aren't. And that's a real testament to how safe things are here. And I think that has more to do with the average Americans having guns in most places than it does anything about the government keeping
keeping us safe, because I don't think the government's keeping us safe at all. I think the government is putting us in greater danger.
Absolutely.
If you want to share your thoughts with us, please do. The toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. But that danger is also something that's sort of that specter of danger, that looming danger out there, is also an excuse that the government uses to infringe on your privacy, which brings us back around to the conversation we started the show out tonight with about the story from thehill.com, where Chairman Richard Burr of the Senate Intelligence Committee has argued in an op-ed in the Washington Street, or the Wall Street Journal, rather, that the time has come, he says, for Congress and technology companies to discuss how encryption, encoding messages to protect their content, is enabling murderers, pedophiles, drug dealers, and increasingly terrorists. Burr has been one of the Capitol Hill's leading proponents of legislation that forces companies to crack their own encryption. But the tech community has pushed back, arguing that such a mandate would make encrypted data less secure. Well, duh. Major tech players like Apple have even refused to comply with court orders for encrypted data, arguing they can't access their own secured information. And that's a good thing. It means that there's not a back door in the code, purportedly, and that might mean that the people using that encryption are actually secure.
You must build one.
Yeah, that's what they want here. They want these companies to build in a back door into their encryption software. Burr said this has become a serious issue for law enforcement, saying, quote, "Even when the government has shown probable cause under the Fourth Amendment, it cannot acquire the evidence it seeks. Technology has outpaced the law." Thank goodness. And technology will continue to outpace the law because government is intolerably slow. And they're stupid, and they're ignorant, and they can never catch up. They're still trying to figure out how to tax the internet. You know, they're still trying to figure out email. Some of these government bureaucracies can't even get their email servers working properly. So, you know, they're always going to be behind the ball when it comes to technology. Thank goodness. It's great that the tech world moves at such a lightning pace because it keeps us constantly ahead of these control freaks in Washington, D.C. and around the globe.
And it's funny you mentioned that some of them can't work email, because I actually overheard a conversation in the Election Law Committee of the New Hampshire legislature to where one of the state reps was asking, how do I get the calendar and this and that? And the response from the vice chair of the committee was, well, that gets sent to your email every Thursday. And she says,
they don't get it.
I don't have a computer. So this woman doesn't even have the capability of checking email.
Yeah.
It's not that she doesn't know how email works. She doesn't have anything with which to access email.
She's never had an email. It's 2015 and she hasn't tried that yet. By the way, email is one of the oldest technologies on the internet. It's been around pretty much since the beginning of the internet. Burr explained that the Communications Assistance for Law Enforcement Act of 1994, quote, requires telecommunications carriers, for instance, phone companies, to build into their equipment the capability for law enforcement to intercept communications in real time, unquote. The problem, he said, is that it doesn't apply to other providers of electronic communications, including those supporting encrypted applications. Now, just to be clear, encryption doesn't necessarily have anything to do with communication. So I can encrypt files on my computer and never send them to anyone.
Yes.
So just because or my phone, for instance, now, from what I understand, Android and Apple are sending phones out with encryption built into the system software, so you can basically do a full phone encryption. Well, but that's, you're encrypting files that for the most part you'll never transfer anywhere. You're not going to transfer your system files to someone over the internet. So even if they were to require everyone who sends communications to put some sort of back door in, it still wouldn't necessarily affect everyone writing encryption software. And further, not everyone writing encryption software is going to be based in the United States.
Right.
So even if they do pass this proposed law to require companies like Apple or whoever to break their own encryption, that wouldn't necessarily mean anything for, let's say, TrueCrypt or VeraCrypt or something
they
like that.
They might write it so broadly as to where basically they're claiming jurisdiction over the entire earth of, if you're based in the United States or have a customer who is.
Well, good luck for, you know, good luck to them, you know, moving against someone who's not inside the United States. That makes things a little bit trickier. 855-450-FREE, 855-450-3733. You can join us here and bring up what you want. It's Free Talk Live.
Bloated belly? Gas? Acid reflux? You could have pounds of rotting, rancid, toxic gunk clogging up your gut right now.
And with all the processed food we're exposed to today, it's no wonder why. Fortunately, there's Nubiotics, our first ever gunk buster for cleansing that toxic gunk out of your body. And right now, we're giving away a free trial to anyone who calls the following toll-free number, 1-800-983-2573. Strict limit of one free trial per household. With pounds of toxic gunk clogging up your gut, it's no wonder you don't feel good. Made with natural ingredients, Nubiotics is our first ever gunk buster scientifically designed to unclog your gut and cleanse that gunk from your body, flattening your belly and combating periodic bloating, excess gas, heartburn, and acid reflux. But hurry, call now for your free trial of Nubiotics while we're still giving it away for free. 1-800-983-2573. Call now for details. 1-800-983-2573. That's 1-800-983-2573.
Concerned about harmful contaminants in your water? Look to ProPure, the most trusted name in gravity water filtration systems. ProPure, with the silver-infused Pro-1 G2.0 filter, removes over 200 contaminants, including VOCs, heavy metals, chloramines, pesticides, pharmaceuticals, fluorides, and radiologicals. We don't just say it, we back it up. The Pro-1 G2.0 filter is NSF 42 certified and independently tested to meet NSF 53 and P231 standards. ProPure water, the way nature meant it to be. Clean, crisp, and refreshing. Purchase with confidence in quality, performance, and customer service. Take advantage of our biggest holiday 25% off sale going on now. Visit your authorized ProPure dealer or ProPureUSA.com. That's ProPureUSA.com. Or call 800-544-3533. 800-544-3533.
What if the key to achieving liberty in your lifetime was to move together with others who think like you? Liberty activists are joining the Free State Project, which is over 90% of the way to its goal of 20,000 participants. And they're already making the move to New Hampshire. The successes are piling up and are proving the Free State Project is a real movement and no longer just a great idea. When you're planning your move, consider Keene. Keene is famous for its civil disobedience and non-cooperation, and there's plenty of political opportunity as well. If you're a regular reader of FreeKeene.com, you know there's a lot going on in Keene. Keene is the liberty media capital of the world, with television, talk radio, and more, all originating here. Though it's more than just activism, with regular social events each week. See what's happening at FreeKeene.com and get connected with video, audio, free books, a forum, and activist tools you can download and use in your area at FreeKeene.com. That's FreeKeene.com. Free Talk Live has partnered with Amazon, the largest internet retailer. Imagine a department store category and Amazon has it. Books, electronics, office products, furniture, jewelry, automotive, toys, clothing, sporting goods, and dozens of other categories. Now you can shop and support Free Talk Live by entering Amazon through our website. Go to shop.freetalklive.com and Amazon will send us a portion of your purchase. You're going to do the shopping anyway, so remember to enter through our site at shop.freetalklive.com. That's shop.freetalklive.com.
Are you tired of governments around the world killing innocent people? Stop using their money. There is an alternative. Bitcoin is a stateless, free market, non-political currency. Bitcoin is money that cannot be inflated or controlled by any state. By continuing to use their money, you're perpetuating the killing. Stop doing it. You have an incredible alternative available to you now. Learn it, use it, spread it.
Get started with Bitcoin at Bitcoin.com. It's Bitcoin.com.
You're listening to the best liberty-oriented audio streamed around the clock, on the air, and online. This is the Liberty Radio Network at LRN.FM.
It's Free Talk Live. You may join us right here, toll-free, 855-450-FREE. Live Saturday edition of the program with you tonight. It's Ian.
And Darryl.
And we invite you to our website. Please go enjoy the features you'll find there. If you like the fact that we give you everything on the site for free, unlike those other talk show hosts, you can shop with us to get your shopping done online and help Free Talk Live at the same time. Go to shop.freetalklive.com to do that. There's Amazon links there. Amazon UK, Amazon Canada, Amazon US. You just click into the right Amazon for you. Get your shopping done, and Free Talk Live will get a portion of the purchase price. It's the same great prices you're used to. You're just entering through our affiliate link. Go to shop.freetalklive.com. That's shop.freetalklive.com. As we go to your phone calls and thoughts, David, listening in Columbus, Indiana, you're on Free Talk Live with Ian and Darryl.
Hey, guys, I appreciate the conversation tonight and the free dialogue. Yes. I wanted to make a point that a caller called back. With Islam, it seems like there's a lot of confusion out here. And you have Sunnis, you have Shiites, you have your Muslim next door who's just a normal guy, and then you have your crazy over here cutting off heads. Mm-hmm. And it seems like there's a lot of confusion, but in order for us to understand Islam, it's real simple. You just go to the foundation of it, and you go to the Quran, and that kind of shuts all kind of talk about what Islam is about and what Muslims are to do. You go to the Quran, and you see what the Quran has to say. And when you go to the Quran, it's very clear what the Quran has to say and what a Muslim is. So the real Muslims, they are ISIS. They are the Osama bin Ladens. They are the people that
I don't agree.
The Quran.
Yeah, I don't agree with that at all. I mean, I've read the Quran. Have you?
I have, actually.
Hey, have you read the entire thing? Or just
I have. And you know,
little bits
and
pieces?
When the Muslims debate the Quran, the reasons that the radicals always win, and I've watched several of these on YouTube, and I've actually looked it up on Google, they have these debates between the moderates and the extremists. And the extremists always win these debates because the way the Quran is set up, you have verses that supersede other verses, and they don't cancel each other out. So you have the latter part of the Quran allows all these things that had to be done. And it's not like, you know, with the Old Testament and the New Testament, what Christ came to do. With the Quran, you actually have – this is allowed. So even though your neighbor next door might not be implementing Islamic law at the moment, and he might seem like a nice guy, you have no dinner, everything's cool – you just have to go to the Quran, and then there's no confusion what Islam is all about.
Well, I think we're confused here because I've read the Quran. I've read the entire thing, and I didn't see what you're talking about in there. The Quran basically seemed to me to be an update on the Bible. It clarified a few points about you know, what the Bible had to say, where it got things right and where it got things wrong. And the history
Correct.
Of Muhammad doesn't show anything like what you're talking about with ISIS. His behavior was pretty peace oriented from what I saw.
He actually coexisted with Christians, Jews, and pagans.
Right.
So
I'm calling you out. I think you're full
Muhammad?
Of it.
Well, the foundation of the Quran is that God did not beget a son. So there is one thing that the Bible and the Quran do not have in common.
That's true. That's one of the key differences between Islam and Christianity is that Islam looks at Jesus as another prophet, much like Muhammad was a prophet by their beliefs.
And a lot of Jewish people look at Jesus as a prophet.
Yeah. In fact, we've actually got a Muslim who is on the line here, David. Let's see what an actual Muslim has to say. It's Will Coley calling from Muslims for Liberty. Will, did you happen to hear David's call earlier?
I heard part of it.
Yeah.
I was listening earlier and I just sat down to dinner and was catching bits and pieces of it while I was shoving my face full of what's left of Christmas dinner from yesterday.
So Will, I mean, what do you think about his allegation that the Quran essentially justifies ISIS?
Well, my first reaction would be, wow, that sounds like someone who's never actually opened it and read it.
He claims he's read the entire thing.
Not if he feels that way. Going to a polemics website and verifying or validating your personal prejudices and finding a few scattered citations that are isolated for effect is not the same as reading the entirety of a 300 and some odd page book. It's a little bit different. Claiming to have read all of the hadith, when in truth what you've done is gone to, you know, a website run by an apologist or a polemic who validates your feelings and who quoted a dozen hadith in the process of his writings, those aren't the same thing. And you can tell a person who's actually sat down with scholars, sat down and learned on an academic level about Islam, and someone who goes and peruses polemic websites and basically what I call prophets for profit. These are people who, you know, their job is to validate the military-industrial complex, to validate the state, to validate the growth of the police state, and to validate and justify the fears of those who are going to vote to make sure that that happens. It's a multi-billion dollar industry of people that their entire life is devoted to. We understand that people love confirmation bias, and we're going to get rich off of it.
David, go ahead with your thoughts.
I'm glad you still allow me to speak. That's awesome. I love the dialogue, guys. I really do appreciate this. This is awesome. What I would have to say is that the Quran is very clear concerning the infidel, and it doesn't seem like
the word infidel doesn't exist in the Quran. How can the book be clear on something that it holds no concept of? The word infidel means, by definition, those who reject the teachings of those who reject the teachings of the Catholic Church. That's what the word means. There is no word for infidel in Islam or in the Arabic language.
What is the unforgivable sin of Islam? Is that called shirk?
Shirk, that would be associating partners with God. That would be like putting money before your relationship with God or worshiping an idol other than God.
Yes. Or to ascribe to God a partner, correct?
Yes. An idol.
So the unforgivable sin of Islam is the foundation of Christianity. To say that God beget a son is the unforgivable sin of Islam, also known as shirk.
What does that have to do with your previous point? Of course, Islam would say that idolatry is an unforgivable sin. It's a monotheistic religion. Judaism also sees the central point of Christianity as an unforgivable sin. I'm trying to understand what exactly your point is.
Because within the Muslim community, and this is the problem that I have, is within the Muslim community, when you're born into a Muslim country, you are automatically born a Muslim. And if you want to say that you want to become a Christian or that you want to say that God had a son, it's an unforgivable sin. And you don't – that's why there's conflict within Muslims, and Muslims are killing Muslims. Because when you're born into this country, it's not like Christianity where you have to choose to serve God. In Islam, you're actually born a Muslim in these Muslim countries, and to choose any other faith means that you're committing the unforgivable sin of Islam, which is why you're seeing a lot of these Muslim-on-Muslim crimes, because they're actually committing shirk.
And at one time in Christian history, people were born into the Christian church, and if they tried to flee, they were also executed.
I understand, but we're talking, this is 21st century.
Hold on. David, if you want to stand by, I think it's an interesting conversation.
Yeah.
How can someone convert to being a Muslim if the sin is unforgivable? That's what I'd like to know now. This is something new to me. It's Free Talk Live. More with Will Cauley in moments.
If you or someone you care about loves outdoor adventure, then check out slingbow.com for some unique holiday gift ideas. That's slingbow.com, where we have some innovative new products for the archer, hunter, or bow fishing enthusiast in your family. Now through January, use the promo code HOLIDAY to get free shipping in the U.S. or Canada. And from all of us at Slingbow Industries, have a safe, joyous, and peaceful holiday season.
Hi, I'm Dr. Sam Nussbaum with the Anthem Foundation. Premature birth is the leading cause of death of babies and disabilities for children. That's why we support the March of Dimes to help mothers have full-term pregnancies and healthy babies. Join us in supporting cutting-edge research, treatment and outreach to help moms during their pregnancy and give every baby a healthy start in life. Learn how you can help at marchofdimes.org.
Since time began, tyrants have taken aim at personal liberties. Now there's a movie that aims back.
The government has no more right to tell us what to put in our bodies than they have to take our guns or tell us what books we can read.
Six drug police were eaten by bears while raiding a marijuana farm.
On your knees, you dirty hippies!
Jesus.
On your knees!
What's the problem, officer?
Today, many cops who enforce pot laws do so only because it provides them with cushy jobs, good benefits, and a chance to push people around.
I was an undercover narcotics officer. The drug war is nothing but a farce.
The Second Amendment says you gotta keep you and your gat intact.
Guns and Weed, The Road to Freedom. A film by Michael W. Dean and Nima Vadavi.
DVD available now at gunsandweed.com or on Amazon. That's gunsandweed.com. Makes the perfect gift. Remember, that's gunsandweed.com.
Yeah.
In Survivor Max 2, School Bites, Maximus scavenges through a wasteland swarming with the undead. Desperate to find the medicine he needs, he discovers a community of survivors at his former school. Has he finally found the safe haven he's been looking for, or will he discover that school bites? Look for Survivor Max on Facebook, read reviews on Amazon, and read Chapter 1 at SurvivorMax.com.
The three most important things you can do for Free Talk Live are, one, share one episode a week on Facebook or in some other social networking site. Two, buy the things you buy online through shop.freetalklive.com. Three, give $5 a month to the AMP program. It's my firm belief that Free Talk Live's AMP program is the best use of your charitable dollar among liberty-oriented organizations. Support all the organizations you love. But make sure you give $5 a month to AMP at amp.freetalklive.com. The Shire Free Church offers a sanctuary to those seeking an escape from state churches.
The Shire Free Church is an interfaith, diverse group of people that may not share identical theological beliefs. As a member in or minister of the Shire Free Church, you are a sovereign individual and may be the faith of your choice.
We don't claim to have all of the answers.
We are open to all peaceful people.
We want to learn from each other.
What unifies the Shire Free Church and its diverse members is peace,
love, and liberty. There are many paths to God, one for every individual.
The Shire Free Church does not define a specific path beyond those parameters that must be your foundation.
Peace as your way,
love as your guide,
and liberty as your light.
Learn more at church.shiresociety.com.
That's church.shiresociety.com.
While our satellite channel is free to listen to, it's not free for us. You can help us cover our satellite costs with the chip-in on the right side of the page at lrn.fm.
Yeah, that's right. We've got a real live Muslim on the air on Free Talk Live.
Woo-hoo!
The toll-free number, 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. If you want to join in here, you can't call on Skype because right now he's on Skype. His name is Will Coley. He's from Muslims for Liberty. You can call on Skype, but we can't conference call Skype. So if you have a question for Will, he seems like he's wrapping up his Christmas dinner. Wait a minute. He did say he had a Christmas dinner.
He did.
At his household, and his household is a Muslim household. Before we bring David back on the line in Indiana, Will, what kind of a Muslim has a Christmas dinner?
Well, actually, when I first converted, it was something that I had asked questions to my teachers about. You know, my parents are quite elderly, and I'm the only Muslim. My wife and my wife and kids and I are the only Muslims in our family, in my family. So the question was posed, well, what to do at this time of year? And the way it was put to me was that the onus on the child to please his parents is so strong that it would actually be inappropriate of me to create unnecessary conflict in our family by asking them not to give presents to my kids for Christmas and things like that, because it's such a central part of, you know, our Southern family, Southern Baptist upbringing. But we got the bad news this year when Mom came up for Christmas that part of the reason she was coming was to get her affairs in order, her funeral affairs in order. She has stage 3 kidney failure, and the doctors have... She's too stubborn to do dialysis because she feels it an indignity to have to go through that kind of thing. So the doctors are fairly sure she's not going to be with us next year. So the idea was posed who was going to take care of hosting a dinner this year for my parents, because my dad's 80, my mom's in her late 60s. They can't do it anymore. And I'm the youngest in my family of 7 children, and I'm also the only one, as I said, who's not Christian, who's Muslim. But I was the one who hosted the dinner because none of my siblings were willing to do so. It was rather than a fight over an argument over who got to be the one who was honored with the opportunity to host what could be our last family Christmas dinner together, it became a fight over who had to do so. And I... decided rather than arguing with them over who had to do it, that I would just do it myself because I want my mother to be happy. And if this is our last holiday together, I want it to be the best one that she can have with her grandkids and with her family.
Oh, that's really sweet. So Will Coley is with us. He is one of the folks behind Muslims for Liberty. Muslims4liberty.org is the website. We do have David in Columbus, Indiana. And David had asked a question that kind of led me to a question that that I'd never heard of before. And David, you'd pointed out that there's this unforgivable sin in Islam. And Will, you didn't deny that this was an unforgivable sin. And let me see if I can recap basically the conversation to make sure I've understood it correctly. The unforgivable sin being that that you cannot believe in anything besides the one true God, meaning that a belief that a Christian might have that Jesus is God would be an unforgivable sin. Is that correct, Will?
Almost. It's missing one piece. The piece that's missing is the returning part. The unforgivable sin is to return to disbelief.
Oh,
after having accepted appropriate belief.
So meaning that if you sin, had accepted, hold on, meaning that if you had accepted the Muslim or Jewish view that there is only one true God, then going to a different set of belief, meaning that you would go to the Christian belief of three gods or the triune God or whatever, that would be an unforgivable sin?
Yes, that would be considered an unforgivable sin.
Got it.
That also... You know, there's discussion of people who had came to belief and then left belief in the Quran, actually, and then came back to belief and then left belief again and then came back again and were still accepted not only by the community at large, but by Allah. So
well, that doesn't sound very unforgivable,
so,
then.
Here's my question related to this.
Hold on one sec, Darryl.
OK.
I think it's a literary tool rather than a literalist statement. You cannot be forgiven because it's stated over and over and over again that you can screw up and come back and be forgiven. That, you know, that the only limit of God's, you know, graciousness is your own imagination. You know, like, you couldn't imagine how, as a matter of fact, how forgiving he is. Because of the fact you're human, you don't have the ability to even conceive of how forgiving God is.
So here's my question related to this, and it sort of ties into what most people think about Muslims of, well, the Quran says this, and so if somebody sins, then, you know, Muslim law demands that they be stoned or this or that or the other thing. Does the Quran actually allow for men to act as the judge of other people in matters of faith, or is judgment left to Allah?
Well, I guess that would kind of depend on what those matters are. Sin is sin. It's something that's between you and God. Criminal action is a bit different. You've now harmed the person or property of another. You have aggressed against or come in the way of the rights of another. You have attempted to prevent someone from their right, or you have harmed their person or their property. In that case, yes, there would be a judgment, but it wouldn't be vigilantism, which is what you see. You know, a lot of people try to argue somehow honor killings, quote unquote, are appropriate in an Islamic context. And that's not true, because you have an individual who offended another individual. And at that point, according to Islam, you must have an arbiter.
Yeah, I want to give a chance to get to... hold on. I want to give David a chance to jump in here before we have to move on to some other calls. But David, having heard all of that, you've got Will here. Any other thoughts you want to share?
Well, it looks like what we come down to is what people will call interpretations of the Quran. We either have Will, who's going to sit here and represent Muslims, or we have Muslims over in Islamic countries that have been Muslims for centuries represent who Islam is. And again, it comes down to the Quran. And so either Will's the one representing what the Quran really means, or these other Muslims are. And that's what it comes down to. And from how I read the Quran and read the life of Muhammad,
You're stating that this is your interpretation. just said how I read the Quran.
I believe the Quran speaks for itself.
Yeah, but you've already been called out, and it sounds like you don't really even know what you're talking about, David. I mean, thanks for the call tonight. I appreciate it. The toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. He talked about infidels, and you said that's not even mentioned in the Quran.
No, the word that is often used by Orientalists as the word infidel, as I said, it doesn't even exist, is the word kafir or kufar. And that's not a pronoun as infidel or something. It's a verb. It takes action. You have to physically be attempting to prevent a Muslim from practicing their faith. You have to be...
Uh-oh. I don't know what just happened there. Skype just all of a sudden disconnected him in the middle of that call. We're going to see if we can get him back in here. Our toll-free number tonight is 855-450-FREE. We do have what appears to be another episode of Ask a Muslim going on here with Will Coley, as it tends to be when he calls into the program. All kinds of questions do tend to come up for Will, and I know that we've got at least one more person on the line who had a question for Will. So we're going to do our best to get him back on here because, I mean, I can do kind of a half-assed job of defending Islam, having actually read the Quran myself. While I was in jail for civil disobedience, I took the time to read the full book. And in addition to that, I have done some research on Muhammad and have done a little ancillary reading. Our toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. So by no means am I an expert. Will has actually studied academically Islam and is a Muslim. So I'm gratefully appreciative of him being here with us. We'll see if we can get... I think he might have some internet issues because he's not picking up. We'll see if we can get him back in here. And if not, either way, we'll still take your calls about whatever's on your mind at 855-450-FREE. It's Free Talk Live.
You can control your health care with Liberty HealthShare.
Liberty HealthShare is like-minded people coming together to share medical costs, which saves money.
You don't even have to pay for procedures that violate your conscience.
Because we all share the same values.
Join the movement of people who share in medical costs and change the way you pay for your health care forever.
Go to libertyhealthshare.org to find out more.
Liberty Health Share.
Together, we're changing health care for good. libertyhealthshare.org.
Are you searching for your soulmate? Someone you can trust, who will never betray you or cooperate with the NSA? Stop searching. With EasyDNS, you found a keeper. EasyDNS does it all. Domain names, web hosting, and managed WordPress hosting. EasyDNS stands up for your internet freedom. And with servers in Canada, they do not cooperate with the NSA. Go to EasyDNS.com. You'll love their services or get a full refund. They guarantee it. And they accept Bitcoin. That's EasyDNS.com.
Are you worried about your mom or dad living alone in their house? Hi, I'm Joan London. Listen, I know how difficult it is to find senior care for someone you love. That's why I recommend a free service called A Place for Mom. They are the nation's largest senior living referral service. Call A Place for Mom today.
To receive free information on senior living communities in your area, call A Place for Mom at 1-800-704-6182.
A Place for Mom offers free one-on-one advice from local advisors and a personalized list of senior living communities you can visit. If you have questions about senior care for your mom or dad, there's a place for answers, A Place for Mom.
Call A Place for Mom in the next 10 minutes to get your free ebook on financing senior care as well as free information on senior living communities in your area. Call 1-800-704-6182. That's 1-800-704-6182.
Why did you move to the Shire?
I moved here to the Shire because there's other people around who take liberty just as seriously as I do.
I moved to the Shire because I saw videos of people challenging authority and thought that I could get support myself. It called to me, like, do this right now.
I wanted to be around people like me who got it. And once I got here, I knew there was nowhere else that I wanted to be.
I've always wanted to change the world. So I moved to the Shire to join people who were actually working towards doing the same thing.
The people here are awesome, loving, and positive. It was for the adventure and for the feeling of something important is happening here, and I just wanted to come to sort of be part of that.
Visit ShireSociety.com to read and sign the Shire Society Declaration and learn the reasons why, if you love liberty, you should immigrate to the Shire. Plus, add yourself to the Shire map at ShireSociety.com. That's ShireSociety.com.
You can listen to Free Talk Live on the radio, podcast, satellite, webcam, and our live streams. But did you know you can listen to Free Talk Live from any phone, anywhere? Add this number to your phone, 213-493-0308. It's a long-distance call, so make sure you're familiar with your phone's calling plan. The listen lines are airing the latest episode of Free Talk Live 24 hours a day, including our live shows. Call 213-493-0308. That's 213-493-0308.
Silver and gold, how do you measure its worth? Just by the pleasure it gives here on earth.
Roberts and Roberts Brokerage hopes you have a happy holiday season and a prosperous 2016. We're available 24/7 at rrbi.co or call 800-874-9760.
Do you love Twitter? Make sure you favorite the LRN.FM Twitter account so you can receive our tweets at twitter.lrn.fm. That's twitter.lrn.fm.
It's Free Talk Live. We may have time for you if you dial right now. 855-450-FREE is our toll-free number. 855-450-3733. Joining you in the studio, it's Ian.
And Darryl.
Don't forget, you can join us online. Go to freetalklive.com. Get interactive there. It's totally free. You get to actually control the content of the site. You submit show prep topics, things you might want us to talk about on the radio. Submit it there via our Reddit-based system. Totally free to do that. Other listeners can then vote up or down, whether they want to hear more about that or not on the air. So go to freetalklive.com, get interactive. We do have a special guest, unplanned guest, I guess we should say, Will Coley, always welcome on the show, who's, by the way, in the behind-the-scenes world trying to put together his own radio show. And I believe we are closing in on the launch of that show. I think we can mention that it's going to be Sunday nights on LRN.FM after Free Talk Live.
Beginning next year.
Beginning sometime in early 2016. Will, what's the show going to be called?
Call to Freedom.
Call to Freedom. You'll be one of the main hosts on it, and I imagine it'll be a good place to get some news from a pro-liberty Muslim perspective. But we do have folks who have some questions for you, Will, so do you mind taking a couple more?
No, not at all.
All right, Will's here from Muslims for Liberty. Will's, Muslims, the number four, liberty.org is the website. Let's go to Jim. He's listening in northern Minnesota to WNMT. Hello, Jim. You're on with Will.
Good evening. I guess the question I have, and I'm not going to pretend that I read the Quran or I understand everything, but I only get bits of stuff on the, you know, what's going on in the news and stuff. But I'm just curious how, you know, obviously priests have done bad things. These ISIS are doing bad things. How does somebody like Will explain what's going on over there to where if you say the wrong thing, you get your head cut off? Because I just couldn't get to that point in my life where I could do that to another person. And I'm wondering how they explain that, if these people are just claiming to be Muslims or if they are Muslims or if it's just a strange belief that they have.
Will?
Okay. Yeah, sure. Well, a lot of what you're seeing is a reaction. You know, these are areas that they've been living for the last 100 years under Western-installed, funded, armed dictators. And somehow, a good portion of the world somehow thinks that the actions of these dictators speak for the opinions and views of those who are underneath of them. And a lot of people don't seem to want to look at things from a perspective of history, of, you know, what the world we have today doesn't exist in a vacuum. It didn't suddenly start in 2001 for no reason. You know, there were reasons behind it. And we even hear, when there are terrorist attacks, the motivations behind these that are given by bin Laden. Bin Laden says, well, you know, we did this because American sanctions were responsible for the death of 500,000 children in Iraq. Or the underwear bomber where, you know, he openly stated, you are drone bombing Yemen and killing children, and that's why I did this. Or the Times Square bomber who says, you know, you're drone bombing children in Pakistan and Afghanistan, and that's why I did this. And as long as you continue to do it, there will be more. I mean, he said this in court, that as long as our policy is to murder children overseas in the name of security, then there will be people who want to quote unquote kill us back, because that's the world of cause and effect. That's the way it live. That's the way reality is in the real world, not America exceptionalism land, where it's only wrong if someone else does it, and cause and effect only exists if it was you that was slapped in the face. And we're not looking at it from that perspective. And we're also not looking at, what do you think a society will look like after 100 years of a dictator? What do you think the perceptions of the public will be after 100 years of state-enforced religion, state-enforced law, state-enforced views on everything? How do you think that's going to change the perceptions of a society as a whole? So you take the Muslim world and you look at it from a perspective of, okay, you've got all of these countries, you've got two countries that up until the last 10 years have been pluralist and had basically no influence by extremists. In the last decade, that's slowly starting to change. And then you have the quote-unquote Muslim world, which basically means where the brown people live in the Middle East, though the Muslim world is much larger than that, where these people live under dictators. These are not Muslim governments. They're not quote-unquote Islamic states or Islamic governments. These are Western models of political slavery with a little bit of Islamic paraphernalia draped over the top to give it some sort of a religious legitimacy, because it lacks it in every other aspect. And then they enforce their own version of law, and they use pieces from the Hajj punishment without any understanding of how they're supposed to be applied according to classical jurists from 1400 years ago who knew Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam directly, but instead decide that it should be enforced in a statutory punitive fashion the same way Western law is, completely throwing out multiple foundational concepts in fiqh, like that your culture dictates your intention. So if Christians drink alcohol, well, that doesn't have anything to do with the Muslims. They're more than welcome to ferment alcohol.
And wasn't it the case, Will, that in the past, in Muhammad's time, that as Darryl suggested earlier, that that Muslims lived side by side with the people of the book, with Christians, with Jewish folks, right?
Well, yeah, in the time of the Prophet in Medina, they literally had a society where Christians had Christian rulers and Jews had Jewish rulers and Muslims had the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And if they had conflicts between them, they would appoint an independent arbiter who wasn't a member of either group in order to arbitrate a difference between the two groups. And then if two Christians had an issue with each other, they had their own Christian courts they could go to with their own judges and their own laws. And they lived separately but together. They mingled in the marketplace. They donated to each other's charities and religious institutions. And it was a community in the way that America in some places used to be a community. But it was an interfaith, multicultural community where you had, people of different faiths, not just tolerating each other alongside one another, but thriving.
But working together. Jim, thanks for your call. Together. Thanks for the question tonight. I appreciate it. Let's talk to Jeff. He's on the line in Indy listening to WIBC. Jeff, you're on with Will Coley.
Yes, hi. Thanks for letting me come on your show. This is great. So one of the things I really like about your show is that usually there's reasonable talk of different points of view.
Thanks.
As far as Islam, I've had a lot of confusion about it because here in Indianapolis we've got a fairly thriving Islamic community here, and I've worked with many of the people. They oftentimes will buy homes and fix them up and rent them out, and a lot of times to family or whatever. And I was, in the vehicle with them, and I was listening to what they were listening to on the radio, and it sounded like beautiful music to me. I was like, well, that's really beautiful music. And
it was the Quran, wasn't it?
Well, yeah. The thing about it is they weren't nasty about it, but they were very insistent that, no, that is not music. That is the Quran. But to me, being uninitiated, it sounded like music to me. It had kind of a rhythmic flow, a tonality. It was actually quite beautiful. And so I've kind of talked with him about a lot of different things. And up until the point where you know, like in Pakistan, when they had the governor there who happened to be Christian, and there was blasphemy laws that they had passed, and I guess that he was against it because I guess one of them, supposedly, according to what the media says, which I take with two grains of salt, that if you even touch the ground of a mosque and you were holding a Bible or something like that, then that was a law that was blasphemous. That was blasphemy. And so, and I thought that was a little bit extreme. But yet, when the governor was assassinated by his own people there, I didn't really see any big hue and cry out of the people there that was an unjust killing.
We're short on time. I mean, I'm not sure if there was a question there.
Yeah, so my question is, you know, as far as that kind of a thing goes, if Islam is not, if people that believe in Islam are not extreme by nature, then why wasn't there a pretty big hue and cry over the assassination of one of their own governors in Pakistan?
Will, you've got about 20 seconds to answer that.
Why wouldn't they cry?
An outcry, I guess.
Why was there not condemnation of the assassination of this governor?
I don't know.
Yeah, we probably don't have enough information.
I had an answer for the first half of what he said, but it took so long.
Say something to that about the Quran, about hearing the Quran.
Well, no. I think that when governments attempt to do what he's talking about, like create these blasphemy laws, they didn't exist in the time of the Prophet.
I wish we had more time. Will Cawley from Muslims, the number 4 liberty.org. It's been Free Talk Live. We'll see you tomorrow.
So the protection of life, liberty, and property is what the Free State Project is all about. But it's an effort to move 20,000 people who understand.
It's about demonstrating to the entire country
that, yeah, we can have a free market, a truly free market.
Making it just a freer, great place to live.
It's the world's largest voluntarist libertarian community, and it's only getting bigger.
That's amazing, to be able to move to a place where other people like passionately believe in being free and independent.
What the Free State Project is managing to do, though, is to put their money where their mouth is. Physically getting up across the country and saying, let's go someplace and let's demonstrate the power of these ideas. There's a lot of kind of philosophy that surrounds liberty. There's a lot of thinking about it and talking about it. But here in New Hampshire, people are doing it.
101 Reasons Liberty Lives in New Hampshire, a documentary by Free State Project Early Movers. Watch it free at 101reasonsfilm.com. 101reasonsfilm.com.
I love My Magic Mud. I drink a lot of coffee. I had stains on my teeth. Then I found My Magic Mud, and I was told it would remove stains. So I paid attention when I brushed the first time. My Magic Mud is black tooth powder, and the difference it made in my teeth in one application was noticeable. With 4, my teeth were as white as you normal folks out there. Please go to MyMagicMud.com and buy a jar. There's 150 applications for $25. You can use Bitcoin. MyMagicMud.com.
Did you know that you can listen to and watch Free Talk Live during our live show 7 days a week from 7 to 10 p.m. Eastern via our studio cam at cam.freetalklive.com? Not only that, but you can also chat with other listeners at the same time. Do I need to mention that both the studio cam and chat room are totally free? Outside of Free Talk Live's live hours, you won't see a cam feed, but we'll hear audio from the Liberty Radio Network. So listen, watch, and chat all free at cam.freetalklive.com. That's cam.freetalklive.com.
The latest episode of Off the Air Live is next after the news here on the Liberty Radio Network, LRN.FM.
From Keene and the Shire, the Liberty Media capital of the world, this is Darryl W. Perry, host of FPP Radio News for Saturday, December 26th, 2015. Silver is trading at $14.38 per ounce. Gold is valued at $1,077 per ounce. And according to BitcoinAverage.com, the average price of Bitcoin is $419. Antiwar.com reports German Foreign Minister Frank-Walter Steinmeier sought to defend his nation's involvement in the war against the Islamic State on Friday, insisting it was necessary for German national security to go abroad and fight, saying it wasn't possible to just hope the Islamic State did not attack Germany. At the same time, Steinmeier sought to downplay the significance of Germany's military involvement, insisting none of the 1,200 troops they are deploying will be boots on the ground fighting the Islamic State directly.
directly in Syria or Iraq, nor would any of the planes deployed launch any strikes. Germany had previously sought to avoid the war against the Islamic State, but Parliament approved joining in earlier this month in the wake of the attacks in Paris by the Islamic State. The vote was quickly passed through with comparatively little debate, despite reservations among opposition figures. The big concerns weren't so much the scope of the deployment, however, but rather the lack of any concrete endgame strategy. Some in the German military have also expressed this concern, saying the vague plan is a recipe for escalation.
You can support FPP Radio by shopping online. Whether you're looking for precious metals, bitcoins, or books, you'll find that and more at shop.fppradio.com. Every purchase you make from one of my affiliates at shop.fppradio.com helps fund FPP Radio. Or you can shop directly from FPP with Bitcoin in the Bitcoin store. That's shop.fppradio.com.
UPI reports authorities are investigating a fire that damaged the childhood home of former President Bill Clinton on Friday and